Freeways and runways 12 and 30 are part of a race course for the cars and stars of the IndyCar series. The art of building a season into a championship. Two drivers, one team, defying dominance. The Warriors of Team Penske take to the streets trying to steal the strength of Ganassi. The 2009 summer stretch continues its Canadian swing. The IndyCar series travels from the streets of Toronto to the airport circuit of Edmonton. Seven races remain on the road to the championship, and only Versus will take you there. The field is set. The time is now. Each driver must make a move toward the season title. May have its share of cold and winter weather, but today, bright sunshine and very comfortable temperatures for the 11th stop on the 2009 IndyCar schedule, the Rexall Edmonton Indy. Dario Franchitti won 2 weeks ago in Toronto and has the points lead going into this event. But by only two over defending champion and race winner here in Edmonton, Scott Dixon. Ryan Briscoe has finished second in five of the last six races. And Canada is represented today by Paul Tracy and Alex Tagliani, both of whom ran very well in Toronto. Welcome to IndyCar Central on Versus as we begin the final seven race stretch that will lead to the championship, the season finale at Homestead Miami Speedway in October. Paul Tracy is a native of suburban Ontario, Toronto, but certainly a fan favorite anywhere he races in his home country. Lindy Thaxton is down on pit lane with more.
And Bob, 2 weeks ago, almost an international incident drama between Canadian Paul Tracy and Elio Castroneves on the streets of Toronto. The two collided and the crowd reacted.
Tech inspector had his arms out to signal for pits close. The team essentially ignored him, but while the stop was being completed, the official gave a thumbs up.
Dario was in the pit lane when I was still on the track. I think it's just a racing incident.
Paul Tracy challenging for second place. Martins as they head to that wall tech straight away to turn number three.
Takes a peek from the inside. Will force Elio high, and they bang wheels. And Elio wants to push his safety into the wall.
And here we are in Canada again. And Paul, you and Elio both said that was just a racing incident. How do you leave that on the track in Toronto and start fresh here in Edmonton?
Well, I really have to, you know, and we're here to support WoundedWarriors.ca and Edmonton dealers or Honda Edmonton dealers. You know, we've had a great race, but we've had a great weekend here. We've run up front all weekend, got an okay qualifying position, but the car is fast, and I feel that with a good race today, we can challenge for a win again.
And you missed a top six start by just a tenth of a second. You say it's a shame, but you know you're stepping into a good race car. You can have a good car, but what else does it take to be successful here at this track?
Well, it takes having a good car, obviously. It's a very fast track, but, you know, you've got to have the energy physically as a driver at the end of the race. This is a tough race. It's hot today. The wind has kicked up and changed direction, so it's going to make the handling tough in the race, and having the stamina and the energy at the end of the race, the last 20 laps is going to be the most important.
Paul Tracy starting ninth, and here's Robbie Floyd with Elio.
They said Elio Castroneves trying to change the mojo that you left Toronto with. What was up with the shirt? I saw you the other day with the number 15, and I love Canada.
That's right. You know, I want to make peace. I want to make sure that, unfortunately, you know, there was an incident that, you know, neither of us would have want to happen. You know, Paul or I mean, are fighting for the championship. Paul is want to win the race. It's one of those things, and I can't have the fans end up looking like, boo, and I think...
And let's take a look at the point standings as we head into this race. Separation between first and second, only two markers. Briscoe only 13 behind in third. Annika Patrick is best among the four Andretti Green drivers. Dan Weldon leads the second five. Graham Rahal is 10th and just 138 points behind the leader. In the first 10 races this year, we've had 9 changes at the top of the standings. Dario has held the lead 4 times, Briscoe 3, Dixon twice, and Tony Kanaan once. Beautiful day in Edmonton. You see the skyline there. Well, Dario is skilled not only in racing, but in a sport very famous in Canada. But it's a sport that actually originated in his native Scotland. More on that when we return to IndyCar Central on Versus.
IRL Racing on TSN is brought to you in part by Honda. Honda, the power of dreams.
Themselves at risk unnecessarily by abusing drugs. Surprising thing is, they don't even know it. Many just can't seem to find the time to refill important prescriptions, like Brad here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medication seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
In automotive products, there's one name that stands above the others. One name defining reliability and performance for over 75 years. Gunk Automotive Products. Gunk, it works. Available at automotive centers everywhere.
Senior U.S. Open, Thursday and Friday at 1 on TSN.
Franchitti touches it. The checkered flag waves for Dario. It's his 9th career win.
That exercises a lot of demons there.
It does. For the second time in 3 years, Dario Franchitti will drive into victory lane at Iowa Speedway. And he will win for the second time of his career on the streets of Toronto. Dario Franchitti will go to Edmonton, Alberta with the IndyCar Series Championship lead.
And welcome back to Edmonton, where we are less than an hour away from the start of today's Rexall Edmonton Indy. Canada, Vancouver to be exact, will host the 2010 Winter Olympic Games, and Olympic trials for the curling team will be held here in Edmonton this fall. Curling actually originated in Scotland, so we went along as Dario Franchitti, our championship points leader, caught up with one of Canada's Olympic hopefuls.
Everyone knows that the sport of golf was invented in Scotland, but not everybody knows that the sport of curling was invented there too. I'm here today with Randy Ferbey, 4-time world curling champion, and he's going to try and show me some of the skills required to play this game.
So aren't all the stones made in Scotland?
That is correct. Most curling stones worldwide come from the island of Elsecraig in Scotland, and they're all weigh about 42 pounds.
42 pounds. That was Ireland in the background last week for the Open, wasn't it?
That's correct.
I remember.
We talk about that quite often.
That was a fact we got taught at school.
Yep.
See, Scotland's taken over the world. So how about the shoes? What's the deal with those?
Very interesting shoes. One side's got a sliding material. I got a stainless steel that just gives a little bit less friction on the ice, which makes it way more easy to slide and to push off from the hack. The other one is just basically a gripping shoe, which allows me to have a little bit of more traction on the ice.
So do I put it back or do I just...
Whatever you're comfortable with, yeah.
Yeah, let's see this.
Okay, that's pretty good. I think you're a little like that one. When you turn, see the way the rocks turn?
Yeah.
Okay, when you turn it that way, it's going to go that way. When you turn it the other way, it's going to go the other way. That's pretty good.
Yes! Do I go in front of you?
Pretty good.
Ooh. Jeez, we got to judge it.
Come on! So,
that's not bad.
Let's see. What sweeping does is it actually carries the rock further and keeps it straighter.
Right. All right, so that was my curling lesson. I want to thank Randy and thank Scott as well. And remember, everybody, Scotland is it's not just about golf, it's about the great sport of curling too.
Hard.
Right.
Get the broom out.
You can switch your camera off now. Don't think that one's going to make it.
Yeah, I don't know much about curling, but I don't think that shot went far enough. Curling, one of those sports that I don't know a great deal about, but it certainly is popular in Canada and one that I'd like to know more about. Well, the drivers are making their way around the race course, saluting the fans. We will be back with more in just a minute on IndyCar Central here on Versus.
Every day, people put themselves at risk unnecessarily by abusing drugs. Surprising thing is, they don't even know it. Many just can't seem to find the time to refill important prescriptions, like Brad here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medication seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
So you see, you get safety, excellent fuel efficiency, and 50 years of Honda race-inspired performance.
Like Indy race-inspired?
Yeah, but more practical.
There's 50 years of racing innovation inside every Honda. And right now, get 0.9% financing on this Civic and all CRVs. So get to the Honda Checkered Flag event fast.
New Bud Light Lime. The easy drinking taste of Bud Light with a splash of 100% natural lime flavor. Bud Light Lime, now available in Canada.
Eastern on TSN.
Franchitti touches it. And a checkered flag waves for Dario. It's his ninth career win.
That exercises a lot of demons there.
Yeah, it does.
For the second time in 3 years, Dario Franchitti will drive into victory lane at Iowa Speedway. And he will win for the second time of his career on the streets of Toronto. Dario Franchitti will go to Edmonton, Alberta with the IndyCar Series championship lead.
Well, Toronto had excitement from beginning to end, so IndyCar Series competition president Brian Barnhart was very busy. One point of contention was the placement of Dario ahead of Tracy when a caution came out. Now, Franchitti was heading out of the pits at that time. So to clarify the rule, I spoke earlier this weekend with Brian.
Brian, a caution is called for. Where do your eyes go?
Well, obviously, a caution's a busy time in race control. A lot of things happen at the same time. One of the things we focus on is identifying who the leader is, where the leader is on the racetrack, so we can relay that information to the pace car. We also immediately look for any pit lane activity. If a car is on pit lane, we have to determine his position as he exits the pit lane and rejoins the racetrack. We have to determine his position relative to any car that stays on the racetrack during the caution. That point's referred to as the blend line on the racetrack.
Okay, so how does that all apply to what happened at Toronto between Dario and Paul Tracy?
Well, keep in mind the blend line, a couple of things about that. It's only active and important under caution. You have to be under yellow for the blend line to be in play. And if you are under caution, what happened at Toronto, Dario was on pit lane in the 10 car when we went caution. And as he exited the pits and rejoined the racetrack, since there's no passing on the racetrack under a caution, when they rejoin the racetrack, electronically, through the timing and scoring information, they determine his position relative to the cars on the track. And the 10 car hit the blend line exiting the pits slightly ahead of the 15 car hitting the blend line out on the racetrack. So timing and scoring provided the information, said 10 in front of the 15, and that's the decision race control made.
Brian, thanks for clearing it up. Thanks for your time, and have a good race.
My pleasure. Thanks, guys.
Now, of course, Brian was standing right here at the pit exit line where the pit speed limit ends. And then there's also an antenna that runs across the racetrack right to this little cone. That's the blend line he's talking about. The key words he used, it's only under play in a full course caution. So therefore, when you close the pits every time there is a full course caution, Robbie, it's very rare that the leader is ever in play there.
It is, and we had to go back 4 years ago. Look at this at Michigan. There's Brian Herta under green conditions, seventh position. Here he is on pit lane. It goes yellow. It's yellow on track right now, so he's racing to the blend line. There's the blend line. Let's see where that lead pack was where he was in seventh. There's the lead pack. He has beat them to the blend line. So even though the cars are going by him, Brian's going to go out ahead of him. There it is. Brian will come all the way around. And then that whole pack right there, they need to make their pits. Brian inherited the lead, and those donuts mean he won that race in Michigan 2005.
Something we'll keep a very close eye on in today's race. Well, let's find out more about that curling throw that Dario had as we go back downstairs and Robbie Floyd.
Well, Bob wanted to know about that curling throw. You said that wasn't some of your best work there, was it?
No, it's almost a game of finesse, and I haven't quite got that finesse yet. But I had a lot of fun on that. It was really, really good fun.
It was a lot tougher than you thought, huh?
Oh, absolutely. My biggest problem was I was going to fall on my ass the whole time. But no, I really had a good time, and something I might even have a try at when I go back to Scotland.
Well, you made it to the Firestone Fast 6 yesterday. Huge surprise for you. Do you think you figured things out in the warm-up maybe to help you a little more?
Yeah, we think the car's pretty good. We made it better in warm-up for the race. We were a little surprised to get in the Fast 6. That was one of those laps I just dragged around and hung on there. But, hey, I got to say to my buddy Montoya, he did a great job today at the Speedway, and sorry it didn't work out there, and it was a hell of a drive.
Well, he's starting in sixth place position. He has to move up five places and see maybe Mr. Will Power, who's with Lindy Tax.
And Will Power on pole, and you say starting position really gives you an advantage, but you have to use it. So how do you plan to do that, especially starting right next to your teammates?
Yeah, it's tough, you know, because if yellows fall, obviously you got to decide whether to come in or not, but it's definitely helpful if everything goes right. And
you got a friend back.
Yeah, I know. It has to be Tracy for sure.
And yesterday when you finished qualifying, you said that was the hardest lap you'd ever done in your life. How physically demanding do you expect the next couple hours to be?
Yeah, I think it's going to be tough. You know, even this morning is a little cooler in the morning warm-up. Man, it's physical. You know, I think you see a lot of guys fatigue and maybe a few mistakes.
Will Power, thank you. And he has finished sixth or better in all four starts this season. Our own Jack Arute is on assignment for ESPN, so joining our team this week is Kevin Lee. Kevin.
Thank you, Lindy. It's great to be a part of the broadcast. Brian Briscoe won the opener this year. He's been in the championship hunt and led the championship at times all season. He's finished second five of the last six. You're going to start second here today. Elio is probably realistically out of the championship unless a lot of things go wrong. Does it affect you that you lose your wingman in the championship hunt?
Well, you know, I'd never count him out. You know, I think we got a lot of racing to go, and he's, I think, 70 out of the lead, and you get 50 for a win. So we got a lot of racing to go this year, and you know, I think we all want to go out there and try to win these races and, you know, collect as many points as possible. But I think it's probably still very soon to be counting Elio Castroneves out of this hunt.
What kind of impact does the start of the race have with two teammates surrounding you? How do you approach it?
Not too different than usual. I mean, we can talk about it a little bit, you know, coming to the green, but, you know, you can never really predict what's going to happen going into turn one, and I think we just need to be ready to react to anything that goes on. Hopefully, you know, we can get away cleanly and get this thing underway, and, you know, we've got three very fast cars here at the front, and you know, we just need to execute, not make mistakes, and have a good day. Hopefully the six car finishes up on top.
How good are the passing opportunities on this airport course?
They're there. I mean, the track's very wide. We've got down into turn one is a very good spot. Up into turn 10 is another very good passing zone. And they come off of very fast and very wide corners where there can be multiple racing lines. So I think we'll see some passing today. The track's very slippery offline, so it sort of, you know, causes the occasional caution. People get a bit anxious and go a bit fast into the corners. Can create some yellow flag periods today. I wouldn't be surprised if that happens, but I think we'll see some passing.
That's Ryan Briscoe, third in the championship chase, but well within striking distance, Bob.
All right, good luck to Ryan. Welcome to broadcast team Kevin. Going back to late May at the Milwaukee Mile, six races ago, Ryan's got a good streak going. He just needs to move up one spot. He's finished second in all of those six races except at Richmond, where he wound up in 19th position. Well, Graham Rahal is getting set to race. He'll be starting from fifth position today, coming off a 20th place finish at Toronto. Stay with us for more IndyCar Central on Versus from Edmonton.
It was perfect. I hit a ton of festivals. Blues and jazz, film, street performers, fantastic plays. Oh, and the Indy race. My heart is still pounding. You wouldn't believe the things I did there. Everything from world-class shopping to history to attractions. And the people were great. And what an easy city to move around in. I'm going back, and you should think about coming with me.
Edmonton, live all year. This is the clean bill of health you want. This is one of the prescriptions you take to achieve it. This is another. And another. The wrong medicine, or combination of the right medicines, can make your picture of good health murky. At the Medicine Shop Pharmacy, our pharmacist owners help you manage your medicines to make them really work for you. We just want to make that clear.
Open the door to the three-time Winners Club. There's a brand new member, and his name is Elio Castroneves.
You guys don't understand.
Dale Coyne Racing will go to victory lane for the first time in the IndyCar Series. Dario Franchitti started on pole, had a problem in his first pit stop, but he will win for the second time of his career on the streets of Toronto.
Ten races down, seven to go in the 2009 series, and Versus will be with you all the way to the final race at Homestead Miami Speedway. Bob Jenkins, Robbie Buell, and Jan Bikas. In this segment, we're just going to talk about stories. In the previous segment, we heard Brian Barnhart explain getting out of the pits under caution and the blend line. But Toronto, Jan, was at least the second race this year that there was a question as to whether a car was in the pits when the caution came out.
And, Bob, that's because sometimes cars look like they're in the pits when they're not until you check the rules. You're not officially in the pits until you cross by the two green barriers that designate the pit speed. So once you're past the barrels and you're on the pit speed, you're in the pits. For Ryan Briscoe in Kansas, he was almost there. He was on the entry lane. He was committed, but not past the barrels. But that wasn't the case. Certainly for Dario Franchitti, he just got ahead and got in the pits in Toronto. And, man, that was a smooth move for that team.
And how that works is, so Dario is now in pit lane, it's gone yellow. Paul Tracy's now the leader of the race, and when it goes full course yellow, you start slowing down. Well, Jimmy Vassar on his pit stand said, hey, there's Franchitti coming down pit road. Wait a minute, we can maybe beat him back to the blend line. So he got onto Tracy, said, gas it up. And Tracy ran the fastest segment he had all race leading up into that last segment right to the blend line. But it wasn't enough. Dario beat him back to that blend line by 0.2. That's how close and how fast things happen.
The league has admitted that racing has not been what they had hoped for this year, and so some aerodynamic changes are being instituted for the next oval track race, which is this coming Saturday night in Kentucky.
And those changes, like you say, for the ovals. I think everyone's been happy with the road and street courses, but on the ovals they said, let's throw some more downforce, but they couldn't really change the cars or even get more tire adhesion at this late stage in the season, so pull something off the shelf. Three things. wheel infills, which gives you more downforce with very little drag, and then two things on the side pod, some tire flip-ups and also some side pod extensions. All three together, 300 pounds of downforce, but Robbie, they're optional. You don't actually have to use them. If you thought they had too much drag, you might not. Think it's enough?
I don't think it's enough. I mean, 300 pounds, that's gonna be a good change, but it's not enough. And when you talk about those three changes, those are between the wheelbase, so it's really not gonna affect the balance of the car. I think where they're gonna have to go to really separate things and create some more disparity to get some more of that side-by-side racing is they're probably gonna have to look at the wing elements and maybe even back off what the mandated rear wicker rules are.
Big headlines in the Edmonton paper, essentially saying that AGR drivers, the three men in the series, have been a bust this year. You agree with that, Robbie?
Well, they have. I mean, before we always talked about AGR in the same line as Penske and Ganassi as the big three. Well, they haven't been able to keep up. And it's just so competitive in this series right now. I think all the teams are within 95%, but it's that last 95%, excuse me, the last 5%. Everybody's in 95%. That last 5% that everybody's fine-tuning and just fighting for that little edge, that little bit of confidence that just makes that one guy stand up in the seat that day.
And, Robbie, I think when you get, however, to the road and the street courses, that then you have a different animal. Certainly on the ovals there was the big three, but when you get to the road and street course, it seems like it just throws everything out. And then teams like yours, I mean, that's got to give you satisfaction. You went to Andretti Green Racing. You walked around and said, man, this is one impressive facility, but you're whipping up on them.
No, you're right. I just got, the first time I went to the AGR facility, I was like, wow, the depth and caliber of these people. I'm like, how do you compete with that? But it gets back to that little bit of confidence you have as a driver, a little bit of that momentum and mojo that a driver and engineer go in. That little 5% window, that's what can make the difference in this competitive series.
And, of course, there's always the Danica Patrick story. Will she be going to NASCAR? Now, after Toronto, she visited the Stuart Haas NASCAR shops, and it fueled the rumors. Lindy Thaxton caught up with her earlier this week and then asked her about her plans for next year.
I drive for a really good team, and I like the people that I'm around, and we've been having a really great year, and we've been having a lot of fun, so... it would take a lot. It would take a really good opportunity. It would take a really interesting opportunity, a really interesting challenge. But no matter what I do, it's going to be with a great team. And that's the thing, is I already drive for one of those teams. So it would have to be a really interesting and different opportunity.
Well, that was very undecided. Is she or isn't she?
And very calm. I think she needs to stay right here in the IndyCar Series. There's still some business here for her. She needs to show results. She loves driving these cars. She can be in a competitive race car. She can win races here. This is where she needs to be.
And I'm with you, Robbie. I mean, I can't comment from the money side or from the marketing side, but I agree with you totally. Unfinished business, you don't leave here until you've really just wiped up, like Sam Hornish. He certainly cleaned up in the IndyCar Series, and it wasn't an easy road, certainly on the Cup side. So hang on, Danica. You got time.
Agree. Yeah,
and time will only tell as to whether Danica will be back in the series next year or if she chooses to go stock car racing. Well, Elio knew it wouldn't be real good when he was introduced to the partisan crowd today, but I don't think it was bad as everybody was anticipating. A few boos, but the Canadian crowd greeted him very, very warmly. Elio Castroneves now gets set to go racing. Scott Dixon is trying to repeat his champion of the IndyCar Series this year. When we return, Jack Arute, although he is on assignment with ESPN, will have one of his in-color interviews with the reigning champ.
It's estimated that each year, up to 300,000 Canadians are hospitalized because they took their medications incorrectly, or not at all. Many of us are so busy, we simply don't refill our prescriptions, like Sally here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medication seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
Hi, it's Fitz with Slap Chop. You're going to be in a great mood all day because you're going to be slapping your troubles away with a Slap Chop. Now look, here's a potato. One slap, you got big chunks for stews. Two slaps, home fries in a second. You add a mushroom, the more you do it, the finer it gets. You don't have to switch any blades. You love salad, you hate making it. Take the stringy celery, take the carrots, salad. I love pizza too, but once in a while, get the veggies in. At least throw it on top of the pizza. This tuna looks boring. Stop having a boring tuna. Stop having a boring life. Here's a hard-boiled egg. One chop, you add the pickle, you add the green onion. And then what you can do, you can mix things together. You can add the ham. You don't have time to make breakfast. You're gonna have an exciting life now. Breakfast to go. You're gonna love my nuts. Watch this. You can do everything in the cover. It's so easy. One finger. Kids can do it. They're gonna charge you $1 for toppings at the ice cream stores. What about fruit? Look at that. Isn't that beautiful on your ice cream? It's so easy to clean. One, two. And pops open like that, like a butterfly, to clean. Now, these other ones that you've seen in the store, you can't clean it. It doesn't open up. Bacteria gets in the food. You don't want bacteria in your food, right, guys? Forget about that. Take this Slap Chop onion with the skin. All right, this is making you cry and making me cry. Life's hard enough as it is. You don't want to cry anymore. The skin's at the bottom. Hey, look, so you want a little bit of onions? You don't want to drag out the food processor? The skin comes right off. We're going to make America skinny again, one slap at a time. When you buy the Slap Chop, we're going to give you the grady for cheese. White cheese, yellow cheese, in the container. Comes with a twister. And watch this, tacos, fettuccine, linguine, martini, bikini. Comes with two blades, just bang it, fine and coarse. Parmesan, comes with a cover, stay sealed. Put it in the fridge, take it out when you need it. The Slap Chop sells for $19.95, and we're gonna give you the grady absolutely free. But if you call now, within the next 20 minutes, because you know we can't do this all day,
we'll double the offer. Just pay separate shipping and handling. So that's two sets for $19.95.
Here's how to order.
Call the number on your screen to get in on this amazing offer. You get the Slap Chop for just $19.95. And when you call in the next 20 minutes, you'll get not one, but two Grady's for free. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get slapping.
When you think of sports and Edmonton, the name that comes to mind immediately is Wayne Gretzky. His statue stands outside Rexall Place, home of the Edmonton Oilers, the National Hockey League. You know, he began his professional hockey career in Indianapolis. Yep, as a member of the Indianapolis Racers of the World Hockey Association. But he made his real mark and put up his big numbers in Edmonton. Four Stanley Cups, eight MVP awards, and a record 92 goals in the 81-82 season. Scott Dixon is hoping to put up his historic number today in Edmonton. If he wins, he'll break his tie with Sam Hornish Jr. and become the all-time winningest driver in IndyCar Series history. Here's Jack Arutz in-color interview with Scott.
If someone said to you, Scott Dixon is an enigma, hard to get a handle on, how would you answer them?
You know, I think, yeah, it definitely takes a little while to get to know me. You know, I think people that do know me, I'm not an arrogant prick. I'm just shy, and I definitely am. You know, I think it's been the upbringing from New Zealand. You know, everybody's kind of quite quiet down there. Nobody's really outspoken. They try and always let, you know, results or things they do in their life speak for themselves, opposed, you know, to just sort of blabbing it out there.
Americans aren't as used to it as South Americans and guys from down under are, that in some respects you had to syndicate yourself,
yeah,
to pursue your passion. Number one, how difficult was that? And then more importantly, when did the syndication stop and you start to enjoy some of the financial rewards that come with where you're at now?
I'd say it must be about 3 or 4 years ago I finally finally finished paying off the investors and bought out Scott Dixon Motorsport, it was called, in New Zealand. And they got definitely a healthy payout, but, you know, it was the only way that I could continue and my family can continue. You know, my parents definitely remortgaged houses. They did as much as they could till I was about 16 or 17. And it was actually Dad that came up with the idea, him and another person, Peter Johnson and Craig Harris, that came up with it and actually raised the money. And, you know, without that situation, it never would have happened. So you got to look back at it and be grateful for the people, you know, putting their hands in their pockets, because I guess 9 times out of 10, those people ain't going to get their money back. You know, it's just a perfect scenario for all of us.
I wonder, 3 years ago, I mean, you had experienced a lot of success up to 3 years ago. Did you ever have a tough time and go, when is all this going to be over to where I can begin to financially get on my feet? Was there a moment there as you started to experience success? You're not 15 anymore.
Yeah, no, that was the hardest part. You know, the things you sign yourself up for at a younger age, you know, it's very hard to get out of. And, you know, at that stage, you're like, yeah, I don't care, I just want to race, blah, blah, blah. But, you know, you do grow up, you do realize what, you know, monies are coming in. And, you know, when you see the majority of it going straight back out to some other group, it makes it tough.
As we talk, well-spoken, kind of low-key, and then you get in that race car, and you're at full song, the octave in your voice goes up, you get, it's, I don't know if it's fair to say you get emotional, but you certainly get assertive.
Yeah.
Are you aware of that?
You know, I think all of us, once you put the helmet on, man, it's just complete rage. You know, it's just trying to control it is probably the toughest part.
Do you consciously try to control it when you're in the cockpit of the car?
You know, I think for me, that's maybe where I have quite a good sense of, you know, realizing when I need to just calm down a bit. And, you know, I am quite laid back, so I think for me it's harder to work myself up. But, yeah, it's rage a lot of times.
So Scott Dixon wants to win. Where is the line for Scott Dixon where it becomes win at all costs?
It can't always be your day. You know, you can't have a season every year like we did last year. The competition level is through the roof, and I love to win, so I love, you know, trying to beat the best people at it.
Scott Dixon won here a year ago, and he won the championship last year. He comes into this year's event second in the championship, just 2 points behind his teammate, Dario Franchitti. Scott, you're going to start fourth today. Dario's right behind you. Ryan Briscoe, the other championship contender, is right in front of you. Are you starting to be cognizant of where the other championship contenders are during a race?
You kind of are. I think you got to treat it still as just a single race weekend. You got to go out and try and do what you always do and win. And, you know, we started in the fourth position last year. So, you know, hopefully we can come through with the target car and, you know, gain some more points. But definitely with the three Penske's up in front, you know, there might be a little team tactics going on. And it's going to be pretty crazy, I think. But so we just got to, as a team, try and work out how we're going to jump at least one or two of those guys and try and go for the win at the end.
That's what I wondered about. With those three in front of you, how difficult is it going to be, not just to get by one of them, but to try to jump all three?
Well, and, you know, at the moment, you know, Elio can definitely still win the championship if you do it mathematically, but, you know, Ryan's kind of the only one that's close at the moment, and you know, the other two might try and, you know, play a little bit of blocking or things like that, but, you know, hopefully it doesn't come down to that. You know, those guys are all going to try and go out for a win as well, but, you know, hopefully, you know, the target number nine on the Vaseline car of Dario can come through at the end and get on the podium.
Good luck today.
Thanks, man. Cheers.
That's your defending champion and the defending race winner, Scott Dixon.
All right, thank you, Kevin. Well, Justin Wilson has been somewhat of a disappointment so far this weekend. He's qualified for a 15th starting position, but he has a four-race streak going here in which he has finished no worse than fourth. And we get down to Robbie Floyd.
Bob, things aren't near as bad as they may seem for Justin Wilson. Dale Coyne told me just a moment ago that the problem was yesterday they were behind the eight ball. The rear wing slid without them knowing, meaning a little less downforce. It was like a dog chasing his tail. They were always trying to catch up, couldn't. They found out before that second qualifying session, but again, they were just trying to catch up from where they thought they were earlier on the day. So things should be much better for Justin Wilson now, and look for him to move up through the pack.
He's performed well here in Edmonton and well on the street and road courses this year. Again, he starts back in the 15th position. Well, thank you for joining us for IndyCar Central here on Versus, the command to start engines. And the start of the Rexall Edmonton Indy is just moments away. 23 cars and drivers getting ready to go. Stay with us.
Every day, people put themselves at risk unnecessarily by abusing drugs. Surprising thing is, they don't even know it. Many just can't seem to find the time to refill important prescriptions, like Brad here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medication seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
Remember how Milt used to lose it when the copier didn't work? His face got all purple. This one time, it looked like he was helping a horse give birth.
Give it to me!
Then
got these multifunctional biz hubs from Konica Minolta.
The biz hub has this remote diagnostic technology called V-Care. It actually calls a service guy before a problem happens.
No more meltdowns.
Yeah, nothing but smooth sailing from here.
Give it to me! Give it to me!
So you see, you get safety, excellent fuel efficiency, and 50 years of Honda race-inspired performance.
Like Indy race-inspired?
Yeah, but more practical.
There's 50 years of racing innovation inside every Honda. And right now, get 0.9% financing on this Civic and all CRVs. So get to the Honda Checkered Flag event fast.
It's estimated that each year, up to 300,000 Canadians are hospitalized because they took their medications incorrectly, or not at all. Many of us are so busy we simply don't refill our prescriptions, like Sally here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medications seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
The 2009 summer stretch continues its Canadian swing. The IndyCar Series travels from the streets of Toronto to the airport circuit of Edmonton. Seven races remain on the road to the championship, and only Versus will take you there. The field is set. The time is now. Each driver must make a move toward the season title. Start of this race, the Rexall Edmonton Indy. Welcome to City Center Raceway. Bob Jenkins, Robbie Buell, and Jan Pekus here down on pit lane. We have Kevin Lee, Robbie Floyd, and Lindy Thaxton. This is the 61st American Open Wheel Race in Canada. The first was back in 67. They've raced at places like Mosport, Saint-Jobie, Montreal, Toronto, Vancouver, Saint-Pie, where we had St. Air Speedway, and of course here in Edmonton. Great crowd on hand as they get set now for the command. Let's go down for those words that will get the event underway here this afternoon.
Edmonton race fans, are you ready? It's time for those most famous words in motorsports. Here to give the command, please welcome Warrant Officer David George Schultz.
Drivers, start your engines!
We've been given
willpower. Starts on the pole today. Ryan Briscoe alongside Elio and Scott Dixon back in row number two. Great race here at Edmonton last year. I'm looking forward to a great one here today. It's really a very interesting racetrack. We'll get into that just a little bit later.
And of course, we've talked about some of the people who have had problems that didn't qualify well. That's exactly what you want on an airport circuit, because there's lots of places to pass. So if you have top dogs that are at the back, that makes it even that much better.
And on these airport circuits where it's so wide, sometimes it even, you don't have a wall right there on the outside. It actually sucks you into the corner even more, thinking you can challenge it and creating a little bit of shakeup amongst the field just because you don't have those walls right there and you have it where it's so wide around this track.
And you may also notice almost every car on those red sidewall tires, only three drivers have chosen today to start on blacks.
Jan, it's a 1.973 mile track with 14 corners.
Bob, as you say, it's just a little under 2 miles around, and certainly from the overhead view, you can see it's a combination of runway and taxiway. Look how wide that start-finish straightaway is. They have cones on either side, but highlighted in yellow, turn one, a great place to pass on the entry. Some really tight turns. Slowest turn is turn seven. Then spool it up. Another great place to pass. Again, highlighted in yellow. And if you don't get it done there, you have another shot at turn 11. The fastest chicane any place on the whole IndyCar circuit. Turn 13 and 14 between 140 and 150 through there.
Pretty rough in sections of the racetrack. We will watch that. There is Will Power, who won his second Peak Performance Pole Award here at Edmonton with a speed of 116.414. Pretty outstanding performance by a guy who is not a regular on the IndyCar series, but he picks up his second pole. He also, of course, won the pole in Long Beach earlier in the year. Peak Performance pole winner, Will Power. All right, let's take a look at the starting lineup for today's race. Ryan Briscoe is on the outside of row number one. So although Will Power's team is really Penske Racing, it is three Penske cars that start at the front of the field.
And it's going to absolutely make it interesting, as we heard from Scott Dixon, is, okay, how is he going to combat that juggernaut ahead of him?
Back in row number three for today's race, Graham Rahal and Dario Franchitti. In row number four, it's Mario Marias and Rafa Matos. In the fifth row, Paul Tracy and Robert Doornbos. Row number six, Mike Conway and Hideki Muto. The seventh row will have Tony Kanaan and E.J. Viso. Justin Wilson and Thomas Schechter start in row number eight. In the ninth row, it's Alex Tagliani and Marco Andretti. Row number 10, Richard Antonucci and Danica Patrick. In the 11th row, Ryan Hunter-Reay and Dan Weldon. And row number 12, Ed Carpenter. 23 cars ready to go racing for 95 laps. Justin Wilson will carry one of our onboard cameras for today's race, starting back in the 15th position. Tony Kanaan will also have an onboard camera. Kanaan looking to break out of a miserable, I think you could almost term it miserable season. Mike Conway, on the other hand, has had some very impressive runs. He's starting on the black tires. Paul Tracy will have the reds on, as he will carry an onboard camera. Graham Rahal also in the O2 McDonald's sponsored car. And finally, our pole sitter will have an onboard camera, as he will lead the field to green in just a moment. But first, let's go down for a recap of some of the things that have happened from Kevin Lee.
Bob, we're looking at probably two stops. Everybody's going to try to get it done of those running up at the front in two stops. You can get about 33 laps on a load of fuel. So 31, 34, pretty tight fuel window. You'll see some of those starting in the back. Go in early, make it a three-stop strategy, and try to get off sequence. Three are starting on black tires. Weldon is the only one starting on red scuffs, but quite a few teams in the back have an extra set of these red sticker tires.
And the Apex Brazil green flag comes out, and here we go. Great overhead shot as they race three wide. And
that is Matos.
Matos sideways. We'll get the car headed back in the right direction.
Just
do one more.
It's not time for those victory donuts.
There you go.
Got to get one lap in.
All right, Will Power got the lead as they came down into turn number one, and he leads him through turn number seven. Now off of corner number nine, and here's where it gets really rough coming off of that stretch. And Mario Marias also having some problems.
And look at his left rear. He's towed in the left rear, so obviously he got together with something or someone.
They race down to corner number 11. Will Power has the advantage.
Already you can see him sliding the car through there, wanting to build a gap.
You know, Jan, and the one thing that you did on the overhead view of the map around here, it is also incredibly bumpy and physical. It's wide, yes, but it is really bumpy as you transition these runways.
This is only the third race that Will Power has led in his IndyCar Series career. He's led three laps at Mid-Ohio last year and 16 from the pole position earlier this year at Long Beach. Briscoe, Castroneves, and Mike Conway is off course.
Not the plan, boys.
not the way that you had hoped to see the first laps for Mike.
But of course, the great news is that he's coming back into turn one. That means he lost it in the super fast chicane that we were talking about. And on the black sidewall tires, you're not going to have quite the level of grip. We know that Mario Marias on pit road, we saw that left rear suspension was damaged. He'll either jump out of that car or they'll take the time. But that's going to be a fairly lengthy repair, certainly putting him laps down.
Yeah, and that's what they're looking at right now. But you know, where Mike Conway went off in that fast section chicane, we haven't seen anybody off there.
Yep.
All weekend.
All weekend, right.
We've seen people off everywhere. Turn three, turn nine, but not there.
Take a look at a replay of what happened as they came down to take the green flag.
Now look to me like we want to focus right about into this section of those cars and see who trips up. That's Conway.
Conway, yeah,
yeah,
it is.
Mike Conway. Now, I don't see any problem with Mario Marias. He must have had some contact later. And here's Conway. Perfect way to look at it. Comes in. Oh, he gets a bit of the sandwich.
Yeah, there was TK going down the inside, so it just pushed up Kanaan a little bit more, and his left front just got into Matos, and around he went.
I suppose we could speculate that Conway could have had a slight bit of damage or something with the front toe that could have caused him to go off.
I think that's a very safe bet.
Our Mobile One track conditions are very comfortable. 81 degrees, the air temperature, track temperature 92. And the pit window is between 25 and 34 with a maximum of 36.
Now, of course, the reason that there's a bit of a variance in what we heard early on Kevin Lee say you could go 32, 33 laps, and that one says you can go 36. It all depends on what fuel number you choose in the car, so there is a variance. If you go fast, you're probably only going to do 33 laps. If you want to save some fuel, probably can go as far as 36 if you need to. But I feel, Robbie, on these red sidewall Firestones, I think you're going to want to try and take the early part of those windows because they don't have the same longevity as those blacks.
Well, that's the way to read it. And, you know, you talk about strategy. That's great with what those windows are. But remember, the idea on this type of racing, the street course racing, is be the first to make the last stop. You want to be the first to make the last stop.
Dario Franchitti, the first time he's ever been to Edmonton on this racetrack, of course, because he was driving bigger cars last year, has an opportunity. And he's been chasing this weekend because he doesn't like Scott Dixon's setup at this racetrack. He's a right foot breaker. We know that Scott Dixon's a left, and just off the bat on a bumpy circuit like this, that makes a big difference.
And their styles are different. Dario likes the front of the car to push or have a little bit of understeer, where to see that they're pulling Conway back. He's not out of the car, so that means they're going to try and get that running. But the flip side of Dario liking an understeering car is Dixon likes a little bit of oversteering car, so they do have different styles and different feel they want from those cars.
And I spoke to his engineer, Chris Simmons, at length, and he told me the problem was that Dario, coming up here, this is the really bumpy, super fast corner where the back of the car stepped out. He said we could fix it, but then we end up with too much understeer, and we battle it every place else.
And he's being chased by Paul Tracy. He has moved up three positions. The driver who has moved up the most in the first five laps of this race is Ryan Hunter-Reay, who has gained six spots.
Well, if Tracy has, that's on board with Paul Tracy right there, coming towards that fast chicane, 140 miles an hour. But if he has any race car like he had in Toronto, he is absolutely going to be a threat to charge up through this field.
Floyd.
Well, you talk about Paul Tracy moving up through the field quickly. Evidently, he might have moved up a little too quickly for his teammate in the KB Racing's machine. Mario Marias is now out of the race. He said it was when Paul Tracy made contact with him, it broke the drive shaft, so Marias is out of the race, although Tracy's now starting to move up.
Whoa, Robbie. Hey, it would be worth checking with the team to see if Paul, you know, usually if you have two team cars hit each other, it's not damage-wise, reserve only to one car, which is what we're speculating on for Mike Conway. So it'd be great to know if Paul Tracy has maybe a wounded warrior.
Okay, let's take a look at it. There's his teammate right on the inside. There's Mario.
Look out.
No contact there. That's okay. Turn 2-3, about 115 miles an hour through here.
Yeah, put
down
in
the inside.
Howie.
Yep. There you go. Tracy's car looked to be okay because that would be the right front, and it's not damaged right now.
Seven laps completed here at Edmonton. Will Power, the pole sitter, has the advantage over Ryan Briscoe by about 1.1 seconds. Riding in third position is Elio Castroneves. Scott Dixon is fourth, and Dario Franchitti, your top five. Stay with us for more IndyCar racing on Versus.
Every day, people put themselves at risk unnecessarily by abusing drugs. Surprising thing is, they don't even know it. Many just can't seem to find the time to refill important prescriptions, like Brad here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medication seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
So you see, you get safety, excellent fuel efficiency, and 50 years of Honda race-inspired performance.
Like Indy race-inspired?
Yeah, but more practical.
There's 50 years of racing innovation inside every Honda. And right now, get 0.9% financing on this Civic and all CRVs. So get to the Honda checkered flag event fast.
It was perfect. I hit a ton of festivals. Blues and jazz, film, street performers, fantastic plays. Oh, and the Indy race. My heart is still pounding. You wouldn't believe the things I did there. Everything from world-class shopping, to history, to attractions. And the people were great. And what an easy city to move around in. I'm going back, and you should think about coming with me.
Edmonton, live all year.
Has never had a win here at this racetrack, so Will hopes to break that mark.
Just takes willpower.
Oh, very good, John. Very nice.
You know, sometimes they ask you.
You've been waiting for that.
No,
one,
actually,
you had that in your back pocket.
Yeah,
you know?
Written down over
no,
there.
Yeah, it's like,
there's the window.
Yeah, a lot of people have said, well, if you weren't named Will, do you like your Will? And he says, you know, which is there another name that you like? He says, yeah, I think maybe Max.
Tony Kanaan is running in ninth spot.
And absolutely been struggling here this weekend just to find a happy balance in the race car. But, you know, what he says is, hey, we just have to keep our head down, focus every session to try and improve things every race. And it's not what he wants, but he knows you just got to keep pressing, trying things and pressing the right button to get it to work better.
Ryan Hunter-Reay is the biggest mover so far. Dan Weldon also has improved his spot. And Tony Kanaan has moved up four positions from his 13th place on the grid.
And unfortunately, he tried so hard to get out of the first group that he burned both of his sticker set of red that you have for qualifying. So he's not going to have the same tires that some of the other people might have available because he knew already he was in trouble and how much work it was going to take even to get out of the first group.
But if I'm him, I want to run both those red sets to try and get up into the top 12.
I don't disagree.
I don't think it's a bad thing. That was just the position they were in and they had to do it.
Yeah.
Go down to Kevin Lee.
Rafael Matos was one of those involved in early contact. It's right rear suspension damage for Jay Penske's team, and he has been sitting here on the pit lane for several minutes as Penske leans over to talk to his driver right now. So an eighth-place start, not going to be a good day for Rafael Matos, even if they get back in the chase.
We saw him spin, but that contact, I believe, came later. Hillier felt his original spin was clean.
Yeah, and you know, the frustration for the crew, for Jay Penske, for Rafael, you know, you're here working so hard all weekend, and they had a good, solid top 10 qualifying run, and then you get spun on that first lap. I mean, it's rejection beyond belief. It really is. I mean, the focus you got to have to just come back from that is
And he's won twice on this racetrack in Atlantics in 07. Rafael Matos registered two wins. But things not going well here for the IndyCars as we watch Dan Weldon.
Who, in case you didn't catch the qualifying action yesterday and you're wondering why the differing colors there, of course, he had a wreck in the first session on Saturday, and it was heavy enough to where they had to go to the backup tub, but they've chosen to use the nose box from the original car.
And right behind him, Lindy Thaxton, is Marco Andretti.
Marco, like a lot of people, hoping to take advantage of some of the stakes we saw at the beginning. Marco starting 18th. He said, obviously, I'm starting farther back than I'd like to. He says, my plan is to keep pressure on the car in front of me, take advantage of any opportunity to gain track position that I can. He was just told in his ear, Marco, take advantage of those mistakes we just saw. But, Bob, they said, just do not be one of them.
Good advice.
Yeah, and I also heard with Marco, you know, they've been improving his car. Obviously, not what he wants, but they make the car better for him to drive, but it still wasn't translating to the stopwatch. You know, yeah, you got it where it's more comfortable, but it's just not fast. And again, frustration, that can be frustrating on the driver.
Did we mention that you must run two? That's not going to be a factor here because most of the guys, of course, are on reds to begin. But you do have to run at least two green flag laps on the alternate red tires and two on the black tires.
And it has to be the sticker reds. And that's what has occasionally caught some people out, thinking that they could put any set of red tires on, but they need to be a brand new set.
No change up front. It's Will Power, Ryan Briscoe, Elio Castroneves, Scott Dixon, and Dario Franchitti at City Center Airport in Edmonton.
Fits with Slap Chop. You're gonna be in a great mood all day because you're gonna be slapping your troubles away with the Slap Chop. Now look, here's a potato. One slap, you got big chunks for stews. Two slaps, home fries in a second. You add a mushroom, the more you do it, the finer it gets. You don't have to switch any blades. You love salad, you hate making it. Take the stringy celery, take the carrots, salad. I love pizza too, but once in a while, get the veggies in. At least throw it on top of the pizza. This tuna looks boring. Stop having a boring tuna. Stop having a boring life. Here's a hard-boiled egg. One chop, you add the pickle, you add the green onion. And then what you can do, you can mix things together. You can add the ham. You don't have time to make breakfast. You're going to have an exciting life now. Breakfast to go. You're going to love my nuts. Watch this. You can do everything in the cover. It's so easy. One finger. Kids can do it. They're going to charge you $1 for toppings at the ice cream stores. What about fruit? Look at that. Isn't that beautiful on your ice cream? It's so easy to clean. One, two, and pops open like that, like a butterfly to clean. Now, these other ones that you've seen in the store, you can't clean it. It doesn't open up. Bacteria gets in the food. You don't want bacteria in your food, right, guys? Forget about that. Take this Slap Chop onion with the skin, all right? This is making you cry and making me cry. Life's hard enough as it is. You don't want to cry anymore. The skin's at the bottom. Hey, look, so you want a little bit of onions? You don't want to drag out the food processor? The skin comes right off. We're going to make America skinny again. One slap at a time. When you buy the Slap Chop, we're gonna give you the Grady for cheese. White cheese, yellow cheese, in the container. Comes with a twister, and watch this. Tacos, fettuccine, linguine, martini, bikini. Comes with two blades, just bang it, fine and coarse. Parmesan, comes with a cover, stay sealed. Put it in the fridge, take it out when you need it. The Slap Chop sells for $19.95, and we're gonna give you the Grady absolutely free. But if you call now, within the next 20 minutes, because you know we can't do this all day,
we'll double the offer. Just pay separate shipping and handling. So that's two sets for $19.95.
Here's how to order.
Call the number on your screen to get in on this amazing offer. You get the Slap Chop for just $19.95. And when you call in the next 20 minutes, you'll get not one, but two Grady's for free. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get slapping.
August 9th, Versus is back in the cage. Miguel Angel Torres, unbeaten in over 5 years, defends his WEC crown against undefeated contender Brian Bowles. World Extreme Cage Fighting Bantamweight Championship, Torres and Bowles, live Sunday, August 9th, 9 o'clock Eastern. It's all part of Versus' red, white, black, and blue summer. They didn't fight in a cage. They fought on a 2.5-mile course at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway today at the Allstate 400 at the Brickyard NASCAR race. And their winner is Jimmy Johnson, who has now won that event 3 of the last 4 years. Mark Martin, the pole sitter, finished second. and hometown favorite Tony Stewart wound up third.
And you heard Dario Franchitti say in the opening of the show that, you know, hats off to Juan Montoya, and he kind of said it without saying it, that he did the job he needed to till the officials took it away from him. So certainly these guys keep an eye on what's happening in Indy as well.
Battle between the two Team Penske cars here. Ryan Briscoe running second. Elio Castroneves right behind him in third position. And up ahead of them is the Penske Racing entry of Will Power.
And talking with some folks about what the Penske Racing and Team Penske cars are doing here is they just got, everybody says they got a lot of grip. And where that's coming in from is the shock package for the car to really be good on these bumps. And Linda, you have more on that?
Someone is missing from the Penske camp here, and that is Roger Penske. Clive Howell is calling the shots for Ryan Briscoe this weekend. Penske, as you know, never really misses a race, but he is at the Brickyard this weekend. Clive has called the shots for Ryan Briscoe before. As you can see, Ryan Schechter here in turn two, and there we're on board with Will Power. But back to Clive Howell. He called the shots for Ryan when he won Surfers Paradise in Australia last year. He has a lot of time with this team. They feel very confident in having him here this weekend.
And the reason you saw Clive Howell just kind of jumping over the monitor there is we saw Thomas Schechter get into trouble, and he needs to know immediately if they might go yellow, because they're out there running on the red sidewall alternate Firestone tires. And I think the reason we're not seeing a lot of challenges between the leaders right now is they're babying those tires, because in your first stint, Robbie, you got to take it easy on them.
But Firestone has done a fantastic job with this alternate tire. Yes, it has more grip. It doesn't have the life as the black one, but it really, talking to everybody, is these tires can go a full stint, but at the end of it, it may just lose a little grip and a little bit of pace. And that's what he's saying, is Clive, is looking to see what the lap times are and if it's going to go yellow, but we're still only at lap 17, so we're not to that first pit window, but you always got to be thinking strategy all the time on the pit speed.
But the amazing thing is the choice that your team made with Mike Conway to go with blacks, I think was the right choice if there weren't any cautions early. So you got to be kicking yourself right now thinking, hey, we got no cautions, but my guy's out.
Not a good day for the Dreyer and Reinbold team as Thomas Schechter, we saw him in trouble. Robbie, what's the story?
Thomas Schechter in and out of the pits. They took off the reds, put a pair of scuffed blacks on it, looked like. He was complaining that he thought the right rear suspension was broke. They looked, they wiggled, they did everything they could. No adjustments, and they sent him back out. So things may be all right. It may be one of those things when you have contact and you feel like something's wrong, and it may not be wrong. Who knows? We'll find out here shortly.
He's dropped back to 20th position and is a lap down.
Well, the front wing is kind of... Yeah, see, the front wing is flapping. There's definitely something wrong.
You see how it's a busted shock or something. You see all the movement over those. And he knows it. Thomas knows something's wrong, letting Will Power by. And he's even cut the course. But look at how the car is just harshly hopping like a go-kart.
That was the rough part of the racetrack, yes. But it's not normally that rough.
Is there something busted on the left rear in there with shadows? I don't know. Well, maybe we'll get another back shot to see. Oh, that's frustrating for him and the whole Monavi crew that's up there. And for me, sitting here.
Larry Curry watches as Thomas hits pit lane.
Well, we didn't see him have contact with anything of what we saw. We don't know if something brought this on or not, or just something broke through the harshness and physical beating these cars take on this racetrack.
And you can see the international sign for the cars going all over the place.
But they're not looking at one area. They're taking the engine cover off right now, but they're not zoned in on the left rear or the right rear or the front. I mean, they're just kind of throwing darts saying, okay, we don't know what it is. Let's get this engine cowl off and get in there.
Which is where the springs and shock absorbers are for the rear, both the left and right. So that would be the first place you'd go.
Will Power continues to stretch his advantage. It's up to almost 3.5 seconds over Ryan Briscoe. Elio still running third. Dixon still fourth. Dario still fifth. Back in a moment on Versus.
Thank you.
Edmonton, live all year. This is the clean bill of health you want. This is one of the prescriptions you take to achieve it. This is another. And another. The wrong medicine, or combination of the right medicines, can make your picture of good health murky. At the Medicine Shop Pharmacy, our pharmacist donors help you manage your medicines to make them really work for you. We just want to make that clear.
Will Power started on the pole in the Rexall Edmonton Indy and has led all the way. We have completed 21 of the 95 laps so far. He has a 3.5 second advantage over Ryan Briscoe and about a 4.5 second advantage over Elio Castroneves. Here is EJ Viso and Justin Wilson as they are running in the 10th and 11th positions.
A great corner here to watch how much the bumps affect and give that kick back to the steering wheel. They've actually settled his car down a little in qualifying. There's like a bucking Bronco right there for Justin Wilson.
And then this is another good passing zone that we looked at earlier, kind of coming into this carousel turn.
Oh, he's in trouble.
There's this window. Go, go, go. So that was just Viso challenging the braking zone, just missing his braking point or trying to just know that he had that pressure with Wilson and just opened it up, but not enough for Justin to sneak his nose in.
Now, when you're Justin and you see a guy get sideways like that, yeah, you say, oh, that's my opportunity. But you're also thinking, hang on a minute, if he spins, I'm going to T-bone him. So he had to be somewhat cautious. Again, bouncing over the curb in turn two, everyone's doing that, and the car jumps all over the road.
But where the series is right now, for Justin to capitalize on the opportunity of any mistake from Viso, you have to be right on his tail. If he's giving himself a cushion, say, oh, I have to be cautious, well, then he's never going to have that window open up. So it's, you know, it's risk and reward, and that's where,
Look out. Wow. Had the lift.
And that's, when we went through that corner, you're 125 miles an hour through that mid portion of that corner when you see him working the wheel like that.
EJ Viso finished 13th at Toronto 2 weeks ago and had a 7th-place finish at Watkins Glen, so he's beginning to turn his season around after a very bad first half.
And, Bob, in a lap or so, if you were someone like these two guys, possibly farther back in the field, the pit window is going to open if you wanted to try an alternate strategy. So it's definitely worth keeping our eyes open, especially if there were caution now. Everyone would pit. However, if there's not, look for some people to peel off early, especially those, again, not that the tires are worn, but that happy place is where your words, Robbie, earlier on those red sidewall tires.
And having said that, as that pit window opens up, this is an easy race to do in 2 pit stops. So that is the strategy as that window opens up. And like you said, for these guys to maybe look at going off sequence a little bit or open the window up.
Well, let's find out what Will Power's pit strategy might be from Kevin.
Well, Will would really like to see it stay green because keep in mind, if it goes yellow and all of the leaders come down at the same time, he has a severe disadvantage because his pit stall is near pit in, while most of the other contenders, namely the Penske's and Ganassi's, are in pit out. So it's going to be very difficult for Power to get out in front if everybody comes in at the same time.
And he also wants to protect that lead. I mean, he's been working hard to gain that advantage that he has. 4.4 seconds. Wow. I looked at that gap for a while. That's impressive.
Yeah, that's you have a driver right there he's getting in the zone, and he is so fast on these road circuits. And again, that's why Roger Penske and Penske Racing is giving him this opportunity of doing some racing here, because they see the potential in what Will Power can do.
Last time Penske-owned cars finished first, second, and third in open-wheel racing was in September of 1994 at Nazareth, Pennsylvania. Paul Tracy led teammates Allenzer Jr. and Emerson Fittipaldi to the checkered flag. And the last time they qualified first, second, third was 94 at Mid-Ohio. So it's been quite a while since we saw a Penske sweep of the top three positions. It could very well happen today.
And if you look at the race speeds, the race laps, right now Power, Briscoe, and Castroneves are absolutely the fastest cars on the racetrack and done the fastest laps of anybody out there.
Will Power's now led more laps today than the rest of his IndyCar Series career combined. He's led 25 laps today and 19 total laps coming into this event at Edmonton. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Hi, it's Fitz with Slap Chop. You're going to be in a great mood all day because you're going to be slapping your troubles away with a Slap Chop. Now look, here's a potato. One slap, you got big chunks for stew. Two slaps, home fries in a second. You add a mushroom, the more you do it, the finer it gets. You don't have to switch any blades. You love salad, you hate making it. Take the stringy celery, take the carrots, salad. I love pizza too, but once in a while, get the veggies in. At least throw it on top of the pizza. This tuna looks boring. Stop having a boring tuna. Stop having a boring life. Here's a hard-boiled egg. One chop, you add the pickle, you add the green onion. And then what you can do, you can mix things together. You can add the ham. You don't have time to make breakfast. You're gonna have an exciting life now. Breakfast to go. You're gonna love my nuts. Watch this. You can do everything in the cover. It's so easy. One finger. Kids can do it. They're gonna charge you a dollar for toppings at the ice cream stores. What about fruit? Look at that. Isn't that beautiful on your ice cream? It's so easy to clean. One, two, and pops open like that, like a butterfly to clean. Now these other ones that you've seen in the store, you can't clean it. It doesn't open up. Bacteria gets in the food. You don't want bacteria in your food, right, guys? Forget about that. Take this Slap Chop onion with the skin, all right? This is making you cry and making me cry. Life's hard enough as it is. You don't want to cry anymore. The skin's at the bottom. Hey, look, so you want a little bit of onions? You don't want to drag out the food processor? The skin comes right off. We're going to make America skinny again, one slap at a time. When you buy the Slap Chop, we're going to give you the grady for cheese. White cheese, yellow cheese in the container. Comes with a twister. And watch this. Tacos, fettuccine, linguine, martini, bikini. Comes with two blades. Just bang it. Fine and coarse. Parmesan. Comes with a cover. Stay sealed. Put it in the fridge. Take it out when you need it. The Slap Chop sells for $19.95, and we're going to give you the gravy absolutely free. But if you call now, within the next 20 minutes, because you know we can't do this all day,
we'll double the offer. Just pay separate shipping and handling. So that's two sets for $19.95.
Here's how to order.
Call the number on your screen to get in on this amazing offer. You get the Slap Chop for just $19.95. And when you call in the next 20 minutes, you'll get not one, but two Grady's for free. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get slapping.
Welcome back to Edmonton, Alberta, and the Rexall Edmonton IndyCar race. We are 28 laps into this 95-lap race, and Will Power, the pole sitter, has led all the way so far. Watching the battle for 10th position as E.J. Viso has continued to hold off the challenge of Justin Wilson.
And if I'm Justin Wilson, I mean, he doesn't make those calls, but I'd be on the radio saying, let's take the early pit strategy. Let's pit now. Get out of sequence in case there is a caution, and you get that free pass to the front because the window is open. If I'm not in the top six, I'm calling my guy in now.
And there's also the strategy, you know, on road course racing is put our driver, put Justin Wilson, where he can go as fast as he can on that racetrack. And right now, he's being held up. So take advantage of saying, hey, let's get him out of sequence and maybe get him back where he's got some clean running and can run a second faster than he is right now.
Great shots through that section. You think of street and or road courses, but this thing is fast. They're coming on the slowest part of the racetrack, right there at 60 miles an hour, but that's about it. The rest of the time, Robbie, you're flying.
And that's turn nine, right through here. Look at the bumps as they come off there. See the bumps? See that rear wing just go up and down? And it's not just bumpy there. It's at the apex all the way through there. And we've heard from a lot of drivers just how visible this place is. And even Paul Tracy's like, hey, the last 20 laps of this event, that's going to be the key. And there's going to be some drivers that fall out of the seat. So it's not just about managing your car and your tires. It's about managing how you're pushing yourself in the race car and what you know you have left inside you to get up on that wheel. And don't do it too early.
Still nobody taking my advice. I think you want to pit.
Here's Hideki Muto, Alex Tagliani, Ryan Hunter-Reay, and here is Danica Patrick, who is running back in 15th spot.
And she missed that one full practice session, because she got together with Wilton. There was a little incident where he dropped a wheel coming off of turn three and came across, and unfortunately was just victim of circumstance. So when you miss a whole session of dialing in your race car, that can really, really kill you.
Yeah, it was in the first day of practice that we had that incident between Dan Weldon and Danica Patrick, and here's how it unfolded.
This is why he's got that little colorful car right now that Jan talked about. Drops that wheel on the right-hand side, the right rear, and just shoots him across, and he hurts that front nose. Look at his front nose. That's why they had to change that tub out. And Danica says, I'm missing the whole session, dog nabbit.
And Danica had no place to go, and that was Dan Weldon's first timed lap. I mean, that was a cold tire crash. I said earlier it was Saturday. It was actually Friday afternoon that happened to him. And Danica's car wasn't really damaged very badly. They brought it back, and Michael Andretti had kind of a face-to-face confrontation with the truck driver and bringing that thing. They wanted to drop it on pit lane. Rocket from the technical committee said, sorry, buddy, we got to get this thing back to the garage, and she never got out again.
Danica finished 18th last year here at Edmonton.
But really has had a very solid year, really been the leader of what the AGR guys are doing. And I think part of her learning curve and her growing as a driver, remember who's on her stand and who's calling her strategy is Michael Andretti. And there's nobody that can watch and see a race and how it unfolds and develops to help a young driver coming along. You know, just he's been there. He's won so many races. What a great guy to kind of draw from his knowledge base of racing.
Back to this Dan Weldon and Marco Andretti battle for the 14th spot.
And the reason I keep calling for someone to pit is that you can... here we go.
There you go.
EJ Viso. Now, what will happen with EJ, and you can see that was Ryan Hunter-Reay also stopping. If there's a caution between now and when the leaders pit, they get a free pass. But I see the leaders are already getting set up to pit. Dario Franchitti doesn't want to get caught.
And so let's just make note, this is lap 32. So that's when the pit window for these guys, they felt opened up.
Dario hits the pit box and the crew goes to work.
Going to blacks. So the middle stint, they're going to do blacks.
Well, Tracy in right now, guys. I wanted to tell you, though, it may not also be as he's not playing his cards. He's not showing his cards. I think he's been saving fuel this entire time. He told me before the race, I think it's going to be maybe a fuel strategy thing. I don't need to go out there and run so hard, so save a little fuel. So he's really not showed his cards yet. I think he's a lot faster, and look for him as the race progresses.
Well, he was running steadily in sixth position when he came in for the stop, so he certainly was staying right up there amongst them.
And now he gets to battle with Danica.
Here's the leader, Will Power.
Will Power changed to the blacks, takes off the reds. I'm not seeing any wing adjustments, nothing there for Will Power. Looked like a fast start with no adjustments. Now back out on the slicker blacks.
Dan Wells comes in complaining of a lot of push in 3, 4, and 5. They added two turns to the front wing and did a rear tire pressure adjustment.
Ryan roars back into action, and Scott Dixon awaits his okay to go, and there it is.
They're all pitting at the same time, and they're all putting on the blacks.
And pits, and this is not a time for the drivers to relax and catch the breath. This is when it's as intense as anything. When you're off the driver just doing laps one after another, that's your rhythm. But when you come down pit road, you're in your crew's hands, so it's very unnerving. But for Dixon, who are watching right now, he's just left the pits, he's on sticker tires. This is where he is excellent, on that pit out lap. This is so important, the pit out lap on cold tires and your pit in lap.
Yeah, but Kanaan just got it. Kanaan beat him because he pitted on the previous lap. Was keeping an eye. Wow, look at that thing.
What was
got
that?
Airborne
I
going across
that
the pumps.
That at pit out, did you see that?
Here's one of the late stoppers, Castro Neves.
He gives up the lead to come in for the stop. And the Team Penske crew goes to work. Down to Lindy.
Elio Castroneves saying this morning, we have three guys that push on the gas really hard, and that's making me work as hard as I can here. He's now back out on the track.
Now let's watch the relationship, because he's been running fast, but is it better off staying out later and picking up time? Or is it better to get the fresh tires early? Typically, if you run longer, oh, he's ahead of his teammate.
Where's Will Power? Okay, so he jumps one position, right? Because Briscoe was ahead of him prior.
Right. Yep.
And again, that comes to your pit in lap, your pit out lap. You really want to take advantage of, you know, laying out lap. And, you know, I talked about Dixon earlier.
We got a fire.
Fire with Kanaan.
Second time. That happened in Milwaukee.
Wow.
Look at that. Well, they're way on that to get him out of there and get everything they can. I mean, those all the different teams pitching in there, the Target guys, Penske guys.
Now, he had already pitted, so he was not on his way into the pits.
Guys, I'm right here. They've got Tony sitting here on the concrete barrier next to the pits. As you saw, they were spraying that entire car and Tony. He is moving and talking. I'll give you an update as soon as I get one.
What a scary situation, though, anytime you see
fire. Yeah, see, he knew something was wrong because he wasn't due to pit. And that's the same thing that happened in Milwaukee, was he had an engine-related issue, came in and it caught fire, but certainly not with that kind of force.
Man, that flame's so scary.
Yeah, Team Penske members coming over to see if he's okay.
And there was definitely six Target Ganassi guys that were out there in those red uniforms.
Yeah, I think he may have, he got definitely some heat in the face.
Yeah.
Okay, so there.
Ooh, there we go.
The fuel nozzle did not close back.
I thought he had already pitted. I thought we'd seen him in the pits. Well, that's the answer if he spills fuel.
And there he's driving back in. Now watch all these guys come to us. Look at this guy in the red here from Team Penske. Look at him run with extension in the bucket. See how quick that is?
Yep.
That's, you know, I just get goosebumps of just how scary fires are down on pit road. A
couple of Panther team members with the National Guard suits on.
Now, it's worth saying that he didn't leave early. It's just that the valve didn't close.
See, look at him there. Wow.
The fuel spills. Then it ignites right in the cockpit.
He knows right away. Get that. We see how quick he got his
wheel
off.
And he also makes sure he got his visor down because he had his visor up during the stop.
That is probably where he may have gotten some flash burns.
Yeah.
But you're right, Jan. The fueler, he pulled out right, but that quick release valve, he's got a spring loaded. It's supposed to close as soon as possible, and it didn't. And there was all that ethanol spewing out.
Man.
Hits the headers and like lightning.
Tony gives us a thumbs up, and glad to see
now
that.
They also put some gasoline in the ethanol for the very purpose, so you can see the flame. So in that
great
particular
point.
Case.
All
Lindy.
Right, Lindy.
Tony did tell me real quickly that he is okay. They are getting ready to take him away. He did say, I had my eyes closed the entire time.
Oh. Isn't it amazing the presence of mind drivers can have sometimes in a race car, you know, as fast as everything happens.
Okay, well, back to the race. Will Power still has a lead, this time over Elio Castroneves. IndyCar nonstop on Versus. Stay with us.
Every day, people put themselves at risk unnecessarily by abusing drugs. Surprising thing is, they don't even know it. Many just can't seem to find the time to refill important prescriptions, like Brad here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medication seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
So you see, you get safety, excellent fuel efficiency, and 50 years of Honda race-inspired performance.
Like Indy race-inspired?
Yeah, but more practical.
There's 50 years of racing innovation inside every Honda. And right now, get 0.9% financing on this Civic and all CRVs. So get to the Honda checkered flag event fast.
It was perfect. I hit a ton of festivals. Blues and jazz, film, street performers, fantastic plays. Oh, and the Indy race. My heart is still pounding. You wouldn't believe the things I did there. Everything from world-class shopping, to history, to attractions. And the people were great. And what an easy city to move around in. I'm going back, and you should think about coming with me.
Edmonton, live all year.
This is the clean bill of health you want. This is one of the prescriptions you take to achieve it. This is another. And another. The wrong medicine, or combination of the right medicines, can make your picture of good health murky. At the Medicine Shop Pharmacy, our pharmacist owners help you manage your medicines to make them really work for you. We just want to make that clear.
Well, next Saturday night at Kentucky Speedway, the Indy 300 as versus red, white, black, and blue summer continues. We'll be back on an oval, the mile and a half at Kentucky that always has some great racing, and we'll be there with coverage beginning at 8 o'clock Eastern time this coming Saturday night. And it's there we also anticipate an announcement of the 2010 schedule for the Indy cars. It was confirmed, and there are the races, by the way, that will take us all the way to the championship at Homestead Miami Speedway on October 10th. All those races on Versus will take you right to the checkered flag and the end of the season and the crowning of the champion. And they're going to announce the schedule hopefully next week in Kentucky. We have, however, been able to confirm that one race that will be held next year is at Barber Motorsports Park in Birmingham, Alabama. The series will go there in early April next year. And, of course, that's also where the aerodynamic changes will take place that we talked about in our pre-race show to hopefully make the oval track racing a little closer.
You talk about that addition of Barber Motorsport Park. We tested there this spring. I had never been there, didn't know what to expect. What a first-class, beautiful facility, just beautifully groomed and plans, rolling hills, and the track just kind of just really is a fast, continuous thing, and the drivers love driving that.
Now, one of the keys to making quick pit stops and track position, check out the in-lap for Will Power. Just blew everybody off the map as far as bringing the car in and getting that advantage before making the pit stop. So many times, in and out laps are the key, especially out laps, Robbie, on cold tires. Even on a warm day, that's tricky.
And I started this before we saw Kanaan catch on fire. I was going to talk about Dixon and outlaps at Watkins Glen. Dixon's in-lap, his in-lap right before the last stop was his fastest lap of the race, and that gained him a position. So you just can't leave anything on the table, and you always have to be charging. And, you know, sometimes as a driver, you get laid back. Look at the Penske cars here.
Yeah, Elio's trying to get by Alex Tagliani. He will do so and puts him between himself and Brian Briscoe.
It's definitely allowed Briscoe to come right back up on the back of Elio here.
Yep, good battle there for second position. Back and forth is Dixon, then Franchitti. Paul Tracy continues to run in sixth spot. Dan Weldon running back in 15th position. Did a little agricultural racing just a few seconds ago. Tough weekend for Dan, who is a lap down. Here he is just ahead of
and you can see how these guys really just hammer the curves with these cars. That was the turn 2-3 combo. There's that curb. Look at Weld's car. So he launched over that curb, and just the car didn't settle back down. He's mowing a little grass, and we definitely saw him do that a handful of times on Friday practice. So they just he's just been struggling to get a handle on things.
Big difference between the first time that happened to him where he hooked a wheel, went over, and ended up in the spare car. So he's learned that when I get in trouble there, just straighten the wheel and go across the grass.
And we saw how he ran that curb. Everybody's running that curb. That's the fast way to do that. And that's where I feel the Penske cars are so strong. Their drivers can clobber that curb, but then the car settles right back down, you know, and gives them that grip. They don't have to wait on the car very long, and that's, you know, they're showing their strength running 1-2-3.
This is Graham Rahal, who's in seventh spot, about 30 seconds behind the leader.
Trying to put a lap on Carpenter. Got to get a little bit closer than that, Robbie.
And unfortunately, he can't do anything. anything from turns 1 to 8 here unless you really kind of dive bomb it. He's got to wait till he gets off of that turn 9, that bumpy, fast turn 9. So he's just got to hold the phone a little bit here now.
Right ahead of him is Ed Carpenter driving for Vision Racing. And Vision Racing got some great news just before we went on the air. Chris Schieffer, who is known to his teammates as Beaker, collapsed in the shops this past week and was taken to the hospital. He opened his eyes for the first time today and is following command. So our thoughts and prayers are with Beaker from the Vision team on a full and speedy recovery. And we want to mention also Felipe Massa, who, of course, was in the intensive care unit earlier from an incident at Hungary. He is in an induced coma for the next couple of days, but they did take him out of the coma briefly, and he was able to recognize family members, so that also is very good news.
For Graham Rahal, one thing we noticed when we were on board, and can certainly see from the outside shots as well, is that he's gone on a strategy to go red-red, so he did not go to the blacks on that last stop. Robbie, yeah. Floyd?
What you were talking about with Beaker. He was actually on part of the crew with Ryan Hunter-Reay, who's now in the ABC supply car. That car was, he said it was just not right at all during qualifying. He said he had serious push, they changed the downforce, nothing helped, but something must have happened today because he started in 21st place. He's moved up to 11th, and Larry Forrest said, just keep on pushing. The car is much better than it's been, and just keep trying to pass people. But already, 10 cars passed today for Ryan Hunter-Reay.
And we might also mention that A.J. Foyt IV, Anthony, who runs in the series occasionally, got married last week to Casey Irsay. And we wish them the best. And Tony Holman, or rather Tony George Jr., also got married in the last few days. So yeah. A lot of marriages going on here. Yeah, Ryan Hunter-Reay having a good run. Tony Kanaan can't say the same for him. A very scary moment when fuel splashed in the cockpit, ignited, and crew members from various teams come to get him out of the car. He told our Lindy Thaxton that he is okay. Back in a moment on Versus.
Every day, people put themselves at risk unnecessarily by abusing drugs. Surprising thing is, they don't even know it. Many just can't seem to find the time to refill important prescriptions, like Brad here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medication seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
It's Suzuki's 100th anniversary, and we're giving you lots of great reasons to celebrate, starting with the fuel-efficient SX4 sedan and hatchback. They're fun to drive with European-tuned suspension and loaded with standard features. Plus, built-in Suzuki Japanese quality. And right now, to celebrate, own an SX4 sedan or hatch for $111 bi-weekly with zero down and 0% financing for 72 months. Go to Suzuki.ca and visit your local dealer for a test drive today.
Edmonton, live all year.
The 2009 Rexall Edmonton Indian Versus is brought to you by Peak Performance Products. When you peak, you win. And by Apex Brazil, the Brazilian Trade and Investment Promotion Agency.
Welcome back to Edmonton, and we have had three gorgeous days in Edmonton. It was unseasonably hot on Friday and Saturday, cooler today. But look, guys, we have a battle up front as the first three are very close together on the racetrack now, hung up behind Marco Andretti.
The closest we've seen the top three guys right there, looking back off with Will Power and Elio.
And it's a case where Marco Andretti certainly doesn't want to go a lap down. Going to be pushing as hard as he possibly can, but there's no question he's slowed down Will Power now under the clutches of the two Team Penske entries. This is making it good.
Yeah, and Marco knows. knows that's the lead group behind him, but you hit the key on that. You said he doesn't want to go down a lap, so he's not just going to pull over and say, oh, you guys go. You go. You keep fighting it out.
And right. He's right behind Danica. Remember, he and Danica had some contact here last year to where there was, remember, this is the place the whole Andretti Green Racing team ended up shutting the door, screaming at each other after a race where they weren't helping each other. So here we're back again, one on fire and two out, duking it on the racetrack.
Yep. Marco Andretti is running 13th, and Danica is in 12th position. And a new coach hired by Andretti Green Racing.
Which is really surprising when you got the talent level there, and you have Tony Kanaan leading that with his race wins, is Oriol Servia.
Yeah.
But I'm a big believer, as being an instructor for a part of my career, is anytime you can have an extra set of eyes around the racetrack or another guy that's interpreting what an engineer's saying or another driver, just to hear it or explain it another way, is an advantage. You're looking for thousands of seconds out there, and to having a guy like Oriol who gets along with that team group, because it's got to be the right chemistry as well to just look for that needle in the haystack.
Yep.
So important. Look at that. Elio's right on the back of power.
Yeah, Will is going to have to. Well, it's tough. You know, the car ahead's taking the air off, but I think he's just going to have to get more aggressive. And, you know, it depends on your setup as well. Will Power has spent so much time being one of the fastest guys all weekend. It may be that when he gets in some dirty air, his car just isn't as good as the Team Penske entries.
This is the 14th race Will Power has led in his open wheel racing career. This is his 51st start. That includes 2007 in Edmonton when he led 28 laps.
Consistently slower than he was going before.
But as stout as he was at the green flag, you would have thought that he would have closed quicker on the back of Marco and challenged to get by him. But it just shows you, as fast and as much flow there is in this racetrack, as he's getting closer there, and just having a tough time to make a good, clean run off. I think it is a good thing for him, as he's got Elio behind him. At least he knows he doesn't have somebody behind him that's going to do something stupid. I'm sure the orders to Will, to Elio, to Ryan is, hey, you guys got the field covered right now. Don't you worry about racing with each other. And you just kind of keep ticking through this traffic. Will's the first to do it.
Scott Dixon works back in fourth position. Franchitti is in fifth. But the interval separation between first and third is now just a little more than 1 second.
It's Fitz with Slap Chop. You're gonna be in a great mood all day because you're gonna be slapping your troubles away with a Slap Chop. Now look, here's a potato. One slap, you got big chunks for stews. Two slaps, home fries in a second. You add a mushroom, the more you do it, the finer it gets. You don't have to switch any blades. You love salad, you hate making it. Take the stringy celery, take the carrots, salad. I love pizza too, but once in a while, get the veggies in. At least throw it on top of the pizza. This tuna looks boring. Stop having a boring tuna, stop having a boring life. Here's a hard-boiled egg. One chop, you add the pickle, you add the green onion. And then what you can do, you can mix things together. You can add the ham. You don't have time to make breakfast. You're gonna have an exciting life now. Breakfast to go. You're gonna love my nuts. Watch this. You can do everything in the cover. It's so easy. One finger. Kids can do it. They're gonna charge you $1 for toppings at the ice cream stores. What about fruit? Look at that. Isn't that beautiful on your ice cream? It's so easy to clean. One, two, and pops open like that, like a butterfly to clean. Now these other ones that you've seen in the store, you can't clean it. It doesn't open up. Bacteria gets in the food. You don't want bacteria in your food, right, guys? Forget about that. Take this Slap Chop onion with the skin. All right, this is making you cry and making me cry. Life's hard enough as it is. You don't want to cry anymore. The skin's at the bottom. Hey, look, so you want a little bit of onions? You don't want to drag out the food processor? The skin comes right off. We're going to make America skinny again, one slap at a time. When you buy the Slap Chop, we're going to give you the gravy for cheese. White cheese, yellow cheese in the container. Comes with a twister. And watch this, tacos, fettuccine, linguine, martini, bikini. Comes with two blades, just bang it, fine and coarse, Parmesan. Comes with a cover, stay sealed. Put it in the fridge, take it out when you need it. The Slap Chop sells for $19.95, and we're gonna give you the gravy absolutely free. But if you call now, within the next 20 minutes, because you know we can't do this all day.
We'll double the offer. Just pay separate shipping and handling. So that's two sets for $19.95.
Here's how to order.
Call the number on your screen to get in on this amazing offer. You get the Slap Chop for just $19.95. And when you call in the next 20 minutes, you'll get not one, but two Grady's for free. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get slapping.
I think serving early, too, also.
I don't think I even remembered getting the white flag. I didn't remember getting the checkered. I passed, I still went through turn one flat on the checkered flag. And it didn't take until the team came on the radio when I was about midway through turn one saying, congratulations, you've just won in Indianapolis 500. It's an amazing feeling, and you can see why people that have won it once try so hard to win it again. You know, all the things that come from a 500, the recognition, you know, just the feeling of accomplishment, you know, you can see why that is, you know, it's pretty cool to be part of the club. It's still very surreal, you know, and it's just unbelievable that you can come, you know, with no money that far and be on the world stage and try and win such an amazing race that's almost been going on for 100 years. You know, you do have flashbacks, and to have those people around you at that point is pretty special.
Scott Dixon, a winner of the Indianapolis 500, currently runs fourth here at Edmonton, and again, the winner of the All-State 400 of the Brickyard NASCAR race earlier today was Jimmy Johnson for the third time in the last four races. Juan Montoya was dominating the race, got a drive-through penalty, and took him out of the event.
And it was his last
intention of the win.
Yeah, and it was his last stop.
Yep.
You know, that was the last one, and off he was going, looking good, and they're like, called him on the radio, sorry.
On lap 50, the interval between first and fourth, Scott Dixon, was 5 seconds, and now it's half that.
And that's because, of course, we've got Marco Andretti fighting to stay on the lead lap while he's following Danica Patrick and Will Power. You can see there's the whole group. Now, you may say, well, why do they not force Marco Andretti to move over? If you follow Formula One, when you come up behind a lap car, they basically make you pull over and stop. And if you hold somebody up for a couple of corners, they'll throw you out of the race. Here, probably because of the oval heritage, you're allowed. Marco Andretti is fully, it's his right to try and fight to stay on the lead lap. And Will Power's got to make his way through. So completely different regulations. But boy, it's made a race out of it.
And it has. But, you know, Power hasn't even really gotten close enough to even make a run at him.
Will Power, as we have the Rexall through the field, has led for 53 laps of the 55 that we have run today. He started from the pole position, took off at the drop of the green flag, and has only relinquished the lead when he made a pit stop. Running in second position, right behind him, is Elio Castroneves, who ran third in the early part of the race before the pit stop, but he got ahead of his teammate Ryan Briscoe, so Elio is now second. Lindy?
Elio, with his best starting position on a road street course this year, had the best of eighth in Long Beach. They just told Elio, do not give up position, but try to conserve fuel if you can.
And now we drop back to the third place car of Ryan Briscoe. Ryan started in second spot. He's about 1.3 seconds behind Will Power. To fourth position, that is Scott Dixon. We have been telling you about how he has closed in, and really these first four cars are running within about a second and a half right now.
It's going to take one of these cars, someone, to either have a little more downforce in the front or something to force the issue before they can start breaking this thing loose.
A little early to force any issue yet. We've got some more laps to go.
Dario Franchitti runs in fifth position. He's about 9.2 seconds behind the 9.6 now, behind the leader. Running on this racetrack for the first time, he qualified for the sixth starting position. And there is Paul Tracy, who is in sixth. The home country favorite.
He got by a lap car. Just got by Dan Weldon. So maybe Paul Tracy just saying, hey, Marco, hold everybody up. I'm coming.
Well,
Well, he's still got the desire and the drive. He had a great run at Toronto.
Seventh place car is Graham Rahal. On board with him, down to Robbie Floyd.
Well, you notice on Graham Rahal, you can barely see it there, but he actually has his own caricature on his helmet. And actually, his chief mechanic, Todd Phillips, put a little Goober sticker underneath that. But his helmet painter's from Canada. He's wearing it, and evidently Goober's doing all right in seventh place. Just behind him, his teammate, Robert Doornbos. Both of these guys tried running an extra lap on that first stint, and evidently their team saying it did not pay off for either one of them. Just behind Robert Doornbos, not too far behind, is the 18 of Justin Wilson. Wilson has moved from 15th up to 9th place. He was working on mileage. He switched to the blacks for this stint, and he corrected the understeer that he was having earlier.
That's a pretty good battle there between Doornbos and Justin Wilson, 8th and 9th, on board with Justin. Boy, you just wondered what the world was up with him when he had some really bad practices in qualifying, but that was explained earlier.
Oh,
and
here comes Matos.
Side by side through the corner.
Matos is many laps down because he was sitting on pit lane, but he's getting after it.
And he puts himself between Wilson and Doornbos.
Yeah, Matos 10 laps down right now.
But saying, hey, well, hey, it's a good test session. Let's see what I got.
Well, he's not going to hold Wilson up.
Yeah, for sure not.
As we're looking ahead at Matos.
Well over the halfway point, 58 laps out of 95 completed at City Center Raceway in Edmonton, Alberta. Will Power is your leader.
It's estimated that each year, up to 300,000 Canadians are hospitalized because they took their medications incorrectly, or not at all. Many of us are so busy, we simply don't refill our prescriptions, like Sally here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medications seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
It's Suzuki's 100th anniversary, and we're giving you lots of great reasons to celebrate. Starting with the 2009 Grand Vitara, Motoring TV's SUV of the year. With a fuel-efficient four-cylinder engine, four-wheel drive, and loaded with standard features. Plus, built-in Suzuki Japanese quality. And right now, to celebrate, own a Grand Vitara for only $165 bi-weekly with zero down and 0% financing for 72 months. Go to Suzuki.ca and visit your local dealer for a test drive today.
Remember how Milt used to lose it when the copier didn't work? His face got all purple. This one time, it looked like he was helping a horse give birth.
Give it to me!
Then we got these multifunctional biz hubs from Konica Minolta.
The biz hub has this remote diagnostic technology called V-Care. It actually calls a service guy before a problem happens.
No more meltdowns.
Yeah, nothing but smooth sailing from here.
Give it to me! Give it to me!
This is the clean bill of health you want. This is one of the prescriptions you take to achieve it. This is another. And another. The wrong medicine, or combination of the right medicines, can make your picture of good health murky. At the Medicine Shop Pharmacy, our pharmacist owners help you manage your medicines to make them really work for you. We just want to make that clear.
What's happened so far in this race? Jan has the recap.
And of course, it was a great start. They were lined up side by side, but already in turn number one, a little bit of pushing and shoving. And unfortunately, Rafael Matos got the chrome horn from Mike Conway, who ended up in trouble later. And talk about chrome horn, here's another one. Paul Tracy, pow, take that, teammate. He's still working his way forward. Of course, the class of the field was Will Power, pushing and pushing with a big lead, but a broken car for Thomas Schechter. Came in twice, went to the back. We suspect maybe a broken shock, but boy, this is the scariest moment. Watch his hand. As soon as it catches fire, Tony Kanaan puts down the visor. All the teams come to the aid. Extremely scary moment for Tony Kanaan. Thankfully, he was okay. Everything perfect for the pit stop for Will Power. A fantastic day for him. His biggest challenge, of course, has been getting by Marco Andretti, but you saw it on nonstop. He's done it. He got his way past Marco. Paul Tracy, meanwhile, trying to get to the front.
And And you can see we're lap 63, so we really are into our window right now of when the last stops are going to happen. And I think this is really going to be the key. Are guys going to go with the red tires or the black tires?
Dario Franchitti and Paul Tracy both pitted while we were doing the recap. And since Will has got around Marco Andretti, he has put the interval back up to over 4.5 seconds. This is happening just moments ago as Dario Franchitti, who was running in the fifth spot, came in for the routine stop.
And this should be his final stop. No need for another stop.
Oh, and he stays on blacks. So he's now tried red and blacks, and he likes blacks. Paul Tracy does the opposite. Yep. Paul Tracy decided to go for the red. So a little bit of differential deciding on which tires you want to be on. Now, Will Power's like, oh, time to pit.
And that is his in lap. Hopefully the lap right there, he put in a blistering one just to give himself a little bit of gap.
So Will Power comes in for his top. Ryan Briscoe, by the way, has gotten around Elio Castroneves.
Oh, and Castroneves is in.
Yeah, just went in for a pit stop. So did DJ Viso, and Will Power is away.
So let's see, there's Elio coming into his box. We see the yellow car of Will Power.
Lindy.
And Elio Castroneves, Tim Cindric tells me that they will make no adjustments to that car, and he is already right back out. And we're expecting Ryan Briscoe to come in anytime as well.
EJ Viso making a stop. He's rolling back out in the racetrack.
Power on black tires as well as Elio, both on black Firestone sidewalls.
And here is Dan Weldon, who was in 15th position. Then the National Guard Panther racing crew goes to work on that machine.
Boy, when they go for those wheel guns, just the amount of carbon, just that brake dust. They, of course, use steel rotors. They don't use carbon brake rotors here. Well, look at this train. Oh, look out, Justin.
Ben Wilson.
Oh, that's because Tracy's in trouble.
Tracy slows dramatically.
Big time. He's back up to speed.
Yeah.
Maybe a little gearbox. Miscue. I don't know. We'll keep an eye on him.
Meanwhile, Ryan Briscoe gives up the lead to come in for his stop.
Now, he would have really stood on it to try and done a quick in-lap. We'll watch the interval, see if it's enough to get back to Castroneves. Oh, there goes Power, but where's Castroneves?
He's coming.
He might do a payback here. Remember, that's what Castroneves did to him on the first stop. Which one gets it? I believe that Briscoe put one back to Castroneves. We'll have to be sure.
Now, Scott Dixon is not pitted, so he is the leader.
And then did you see the gap there with that camera pulled out? The distance that Power has between the Team Penske cars of Briscoe and Castroneves? Yep.
Here's Scott. He enters the pits.
Again, we talked about it earlier, pit in and pit out laps. This guy you're looking at right now is as good as anybody at coming in on that pit in lap when it counts.
Chip Ganassi is not in Edmonton, not feeling well, staying back home, and he's watching his driver pit, Lindy.
And Dixon is getting black tires, and they told him you are faster than the Penske cars, you are faster than most of the cars in front of you. Said, hey, it's not going to be easier. What? Will Power just went by, right, guys?
He's going to get him, Will Power got him, but he might get out in second.
No, I think he's got a straight run down there to two. He got it. But remember, now he's on cold tires. They're not up to temperature and pressure, and that guy chasing him right there has got warm, sticky tires. Oh, look at him, pressure.
Look at this. Two, three, and four.
And it's Briscoe, so that confirms it. He got a position up on Castroneves, though, all over him.
And he needs to do it now. Now's the window of opportunity. Don't let Dixon get some temperature and pressure in those tires.
And they're on reds, and Dixon's on black.
They raced around at turn 10. Good place to pass. Didn't there. They'll have another opportunity coming up here as they go to turn 11.
See, Briscoe is on reds, but Castroneves is on black, so we got a red sandwich here.
Oh, and Dixon locks him up.
He's going for it.
That is the window. Now can Elio take advantage of it and getting a run on Dixon off of 12? He's looking. No, it's not going to happen. Well, I love love that strategy, Jan, with Briscoe on the reds. I think the red tires are anywhere from 3 to 5 tenths a lap faster. But do they taper off? When we get to lap 55, are we going to see Briscoe taper off? Excuse me, not 55.
At this point, I don't think he cares. We've seen what happens. Once you get track position here, it's Berger to pass. But this is a nice, aggressive move. He just stands on a seize right there. The Dixon's in trouble. Skids to the inside aggressively. And that was his moment. Again, that's because Dixon is pushing hard. The tires went up the temperature. And just like you said, Robbie, he seized the moment.
Yeah, that was it. Great.
Now is Elio going to be able to get around him?
I don't know. I think Elio now is going to be stuck behind him.
Yeah.
Until Dixon has maybe a little hiccup or a miscue. And as we said earlier, for Elio to take advantage of any miscue, he's got to be right on his attenuator, right on that rear wing to take advantage of it.
Well, some excitement there for a while, but still, Will Power continues to lead this race now 7.8 seconds ahead of Briscoe. Dixon's third, then Castroneves and Franchini.
Themselves at risk unnecessarily by abusing drugs. Surprising thing is, they don't even know it. Many just can't seem to find the time to refill important prescriptions, like Brad here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medication seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
Tour de France is probably one of the greatest sporting events in the world, really.
There's a lot of similarities. Concentration, focus, strategy.
The mental aspect of things is probably one of the most similar. When you start to lose concentration in a race car, you start to make mistakes.
Oh! The back. Ooh.
That's nasty.
Teamwork, I mean, that's all we have, and that's all they have.
It's similar strategy. You got to wait until the end to push hard. Finishing positions important as you go from day to day, just as it is from race to race for us.
When you have, like, people in front of you, you draft as well.
A little bit easier for us that we just have to press one pedal to have the power. They have to have the power in their legs.
It's not the Honda engine, you know, I mean, it's your legs, and whoever had more of that, it's definitely going to be an advantage.
Well, the Tour de France has finally reached Paris after 3 weeks. Recap the action and excitement of the final stage of the greatest riders in the world descend on the Champs-Élysées. The Tour de France expanded coverage concludes tonight at 8 o'clock Eastern, only on Versus, available on Versus HD. And one of the true constant watchers of the Tour de France was Jan Beekes.
And funny that we're now going with the leader, who's in yellow. And if you're a Tour de France fan,
right,
you know that the leader wears yellow. So there you go.
All right. Here are the top 10 as we have completed 69 of 95 laps. Power first down to Robert Doornbos, who is running in the 10th position. We're going to take another break so we can cover the final stages of this event. Stay with us for more from Edmonton, Alberta.
It's estimated that each year, up to 300,000 Canadians are hospitalized because they took their medications incorrectly, or not at all. Many of us are so busy we simply don't refill our prescriptions, like Sally here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medication seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
We know you've waited all year for this. The Kegs Lobster Summer is back. Indulge until August 23rd.
All kinds of interesting things going on at the racetrack, some of which you saw on Nonstop. There is Marco Andretti,
who just got pushed off the racetrack with one big aggressive move. Definitely got us screaming in the booth, and that's because you got to make aggressive moves first at Scott Dixon. And when you do that, Robbie, now he's lost momentum.
He has, and Elio has to seize that and get his nose in here as they go into turn two. And he does. And Marco, good heads-up drive. He doesn't try to stay on the track. He's like, I'll just go through the grass. That's okay.
Now check this out. A few laps ago, Danica Patrick leaves the pits. She's just getting up to speed. And behind is Ryan Briscoe. She's not quite there. Ryan Briscoe is going as quickly as he can, decides to make an aggressive move. And look at that, across the grass. He knows he doesn't want to get stuck behind. He puts Danica back there with the others. Leaders fighting to get by. This is, makes for some good action.
Great, great move there by him, just jamming that car in there saying, I want that spot.
Danica Patrick is running in 11th. Marco Andretti is in 10th position.
You know, Briscoe had no choice in terms of what he had to do. I mean, he could have been thinking big picture championship, but if he wants to get close to power, the last thing he needed to do was get hung up behind Danica on that.
Down to Robbie Floyd, who has more on Marco.
Well, I just wanted to, more in general about the guys going in the grass during the driver's meeting, Ryan Barnhart told him, if you're being lapped and you're in that position and you can't cut across the grass, do so to help the other guys. So it's not necessarily a case of getting weeded and knocked into the grass. He said, do that. If it can help him out, it might be much more safer.
Yeah, that was a case where that wasn't a courtesy call. That was like, if I don't go through the grass, I'm going to end up in the wall.
I need some of these guys to come by my house and mow my lawn. Let's do some of that courtesy stuff there.
Elio and Ryan Briscoe.
Now, wait a minute. That's a change. Castro Neves has got by Briscoe because Briscoe, after that last round of pit stops, was ahead of him. So Castro Neves has put a move. Oh, is he in trouble? Briscoe seems to be losing ground.
And that's on board with Conway, who's laps down. We know he went off the first lap. Obviously, they got him back out and running. But you're right. He's all over Briscoe.
Goes on reds. And the first thing you said was they'll be faster first, but will they be faster later? Maybe those reds are starting to fall off.
Boy, it seems so early for him to be falling off. I mean, you know, it should go pretty close to the stint. I would have thought it was the last five laps. Or maybe he says, okay, I'm just going to slow it down here. I don't think so. not to that extent. You're not, you know, everybody's made their last stop.
Conway is 32 laps down, but he's staying right with Ryan.
Well, we saw the same thing for Rafael Matos. You know, don't give up. This isn't for position, but he's going to come back here next year. You can learn a lot if you get back out there and push.
Yeah.
Wow, lap 73, he had a major issue.
So do you think he maybe flat spotted these tires and he knows he's flat spotted them? And so what happens if you flat spot a front tire, every time you go to the brake pedal, the right front and the left front, it gets on that area where you've locked up the tire. And if you're really aggressive, it will always cycle back to that one spot and continue to lock up. And the only way to not have that happen is you can't brake as hard, therefore you're not going to go as slow.
That the fastest lap of the race has just been turned by Mike Conway.
Well, you gotta look for something positive.
Hadn't been very much today, has it, Robert?
Well, no. But again, you know, that goes back to my buddy Jan here, who said, you know, get the guy back out there. He's going to come back and race here next year. Go out there and learn this racetrack and just set the fastest lap. So that's... Sometimes you got to search pretty deep for that, for that light bulb, and we just got it.
Yep.
But now what he needs to be cautious is Briscoe's in the hunt here. You know, Briscoe's in fourth position. We're on board with Mike. He's not in the game. So the last thing he needs to do is get up in front of Briscoe and mess up what he's got going on. Unless Briscoe really, really starts backing up more than he already is. Look at how clear that onboard is. Don't you love it? Turn one.
Great stuff.
This is where everybody's hammering the curb right there. Did you see Briscoe go over that curb? And that Penske car just settles right back down. Plenty of grip.
Yeah, I know that Mike Conway had not the start you wanted, but he has impressed a lot of people this weekend. And doing the fastest lap of the race is part of that. He's got some speed, this boy.
Yeah, quick drive. No question about it. It will come.
Well, Kevin Lee is with Tony Kanaan, and we are certainly glad to see that he is okay, Kevin.
Yes, we are, Bob. Very scary and frightening moment from your perspective. What are you seeing in the cockpit other than lots of flames?
Okay, I felt the spray, and I knew it was a fuel. So at that point, I wanted to get out of the pit so I don't get my guys burned. And then I closed my eyes and you can see there, as soon as we go out, it's a big splash. So I knew there was fuel there. And I just closed my eyes, hold my breath, and then I started to try to get out. I want to thank Penske and Panther Racing. The guys they definitely saved me. And, I was trapped in the car for a bit. Second-degree burns in both of my hands, a little bit on my face. But I'm okay. I think I wanted to come back and set the world on fire, but not in that way.
Good to see you're okay. And by the way, his fueler, Brooke Hall, also spent some time at the medical center. He has some slight burns on his feet, but he's okay and has been released. Bob?
Oh, boy.
Uh-oh. Ryan Hunter-Reay had such a great race going.
He is without a rear wing, or it is not where it's supposed to be. Ryan Hunter-Reay shuts off the engine, and he was running in 16th spot. Let's see what happened. Whoa.
So that's turn eight on the backside of the straightaway. Again, a pretty fast corner through there. Third gear, probably about 100 miles an hour. It looks like he just got the rear wing, though. I don't think there's any suspension damage. So you see on the left of your screen, there's somebody holding a rear wing. As soon as these guys can get that off, they'll get that on. He's going to lose a lap, but he'll be able to get out there
and race with Mike Conway.
Yeah. We haven't had a full course caution. It's amazing.
Wow.
And the Indy Lights didn't either. How about that?
Well, how about that?
I think we'll be talking to lots of people then. What do you think?
Yeah, we've got a few minutes to fill here, but...
The day is young, as they say, Bob.
That's right.
Well, they popped the engine cowling off, so they must have had to do that to get to something on top of the attenuator. That's where that rear wing mounts back onto. Hasn't been the best of marriage, if you want to say that, between Ryan Hunter-Reay and Coyne. I mean, they really struggled. The first race he did at Iowa, there was an incident on the first lap. And they haven't gotten the momentum they'd like, which is too bad.
Watching Scott Dixon and Elio Castroneves here, second and third. They're about 4.5 seconds behind the leader, Will Power.
Ahead. He saw Ed Carpenter, and that's the time that you start thinking about, can I use lap traffic to help me? So you start thinking ahead, saying, well, if he catches him here, maybe I can get a run, because on your own, it's virtually impossible to make a pass for a position without taking a big risk. But if you start to plan and get a lap car, just in the right place, it can definitely help.
Down to Lindy Thaxton. What is the situation with Ryan Briscoe?
Well, we heard that there was something wrong in the rear, saying that it's not tires, but something in the rear just doesn't feel right. And I went over to Clive Halley, standing there with his stopwatch timing it, and he said, you know, I think we're okay. I think we're going to be fine.
Okay. Well, he's off by 9.
seconds right now, about 4.5 seconds behind second and third, and 9 behind the leader.
And that last lap time by, if you look at the three guys in front of Power, Dixon, Castroneves, they were all running about 3 or 4 tenths a lap faster than them. Yeah. So I wouldn't say everything's fine.
I would say that's correct. We have less than 15 laps to go in this one. It's still Will Power showing the way over Dixon, Castroneves, Briscoe, and Fred Keeney.
It's estimated that each year, up to 300,000 Canadians are hospitalized because they took their medications incorrectly, or not at all. Many of us are so busy we simply don't refill our prescriptions, like Sally here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medications seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
Ford has great news this summer. Now everybody gets employee pricing, so you pay what we pay. That could mean up to $15,000 in price adjustments. Plus, we're inviting you to take the Drive One Challenge, because we believe once you drive a Ford, you won't want to drive anything else. With employee pricing, there's no better time to buy a Ford. Get your employee price at your local Ford store or Ford.ca.
Bob Jenkins, Robbie Buell, Jan Vegas, Robbie Floyd, Kevin Lee, and Lindy Thaxton back at Edmonton as we now have a battle for second spot as Scott Dixon got a little loose and allowed Elio to close in. So this is the battle for second position, and here comes third back there, Ryan Briscoe.
In a great position for Elio right now, because he's definitely pounding the back of Dixon. But you saw that slower car up ahead of him, Ed Carpenter. So now is the time where he just may get a little bit of a hiccup out of Dixon. So as I'm Elio, I'm going to stay right on the tail of Dixon, just as they are trying to work their way by Carpenter.
It was a great segment, the In Color, where he talked about controlling rage, that he was a laid-back guy, and that for him it was actually sometimes more about getting revved up than it was about holding back. But when he has a car that starts to step out on you, that's where you got to control your rage, because if you push too hard, you end up backwards, and he needs points here.
Yeah. But, you know, just because you're a quiet demeanor or low, come off as a low-key demeanor outside their car, when these guys put the helmet on, I mean, they flick a light switch. You know, they may sound wound up and stuff in the car, but they know exactly what they want to get from it and do. Some of them go a little bit far and use some better words of describing it when they put that helmet on and do some extra gestures.
Oh, he's close. He's close, Robbie.
Yeah, he's... And that's the tease look. That's, I'm just going to fill your mirror, let you know I'm here.
This is where he had a little trouble last time, did Scott Dixon.
Yeah.
Since Kansas on April the 26th, that's where Scott Dixon started to put together a string of finishes. His worst finish has been sixth during that time period. That was at Indianapolis. Otherwise, it's been 3 wins, a third, a fifth, and a fourth.
I really would have liked to see more how this would have developed from the standpoint. Briscoe's on the red tires. The top three guys, Power, Dixon, Castroneves, they're all on the black Firestone sidewalls. And I truly think the red Firestones were a little bit quicker, but unfortunately he's got something else going on, that is Briscoe, that's made him slip back from those guys. I just would like to see how that size done for our knowledge of what Firestone does with providing us the primary and the alternate tires.
Dario Franchitti still runs fifth, about 19 seconds behind the leader. See the new sponsorship on the side pods of the car, Vaseline Men Lotion.
Good-looking car.
There's Robert Dornbos blowing by Ryan Unaray.
But we just saw him in the pit, so he was just being courtesy. He's got a rear wing on there. He's just going to let the guys that are out there racing get by and find a good segment out on the racetrack and finish this thing out.
Oh, but here they come, because Ryan Unaray has now slowed Ed Carpenter.
Oh.
So now they're going to be closing on two cars battling, not
Look
for the lead. This is going to get good.
Elio smells blood. Wouldn't you? There it is.
Oh.
continues. Oh. Scott goes outside, and Elio goes inside, and Elio gets second.
That was an aggressive move.
Well, that's it. That's what you wait for, is that whole mix it up. Throw the dice.
Let's take a look at that again.
Look at this. So this is turn 10. Now, this is where it all happens, down in the carousel turn here, turn 11.
Now, right here, Dixon can't see Castro Neves because he split at Carpenter. But he did check the mirror and gave him room. He knows discretion is the better part of valor, but nice job, Castro Neves.
Less than 10 laps to go in this one. Will Power continues to lead. Elio and Scott Dixon are about 7 seconds behind, battling for the second spot.
It was perfect. I hit a ton of festivals. Blues and jazz, film, street performers, fantastic plays. Oh, and the Indy race. My heart is still pounding. You wouldn't believe the things I did there. Everything from world-class shopping, to history, to attractions. And the people were great. And what an easy city to move around in. I'm going back, and you should think about coming with me.
Edmonton, live all year.
So you see, you get safety, excellent fuel efficiency, and 50 years of Honda race-inspired performance.
Like Indy race-inspired?
Yeah, but more practical.
There's 50 years of racing innovation inside every Honda. And right now, get 0.9% financing on this Civic and all CRVs. So get to the Honda Checkered Flag event fast.
It's estimated that each year, up to 300,000 Canadians are hospitalized because they took their medications incorrectly, or not at all. Many of us are so busy we simply don't refill our prescriptions, like Sally here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medications seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
On board with Will Power, and this could be a 1-2-3 finish for Team Penske, although Scott Dixon right now is preventing that from happening. But as you can see, the last time that they swept the first three positions in a race was in 94 at Nazareth, Pennsylvania, when Paul Tracy was the winner. Right now it's Power, Castro Neves, Dixon, and Briscoe. But what about Will Power? Does Roger Penske give him a full-time ride in 2010?
I'm not sure it happens in 2010, but he's obviously part of that Penske family, and I think that's why we see him in the position he is right now in this 12 car for Penske Racing, is to keep bringing him along. Is he going to slot in when you got guys like Castro Neves and Briscoe right now? I don't know. I mean, there's obviously some master plan there, and it's a good one. And if I was Will Power, I'd be, you tell me what you want me to do.
Tell me when you want me to win races. I'll be there.
And my day will come. My day will come.
Down to Kevin Lee.
And remember, last year, Will had a pretty nice season in his debut in the IndyCar Series with KV Racing Technology. And he was one of those guys on the outside looking in during the winter, and he had a dilemma. Is he going to take a lesser ride or this that guaranteed nothing more than really one race? I think everybody agrees that this was the best opportunity, even with nothing guaranteed. Just being involved with Penske and having an opportunity when you do race to run up front, it's eventually going to work out for Will Power. If not with Penske, he's shown that he deserves a good ride.
He's sure showing it today. He has just dominated this race. Has led 83 of the 88 laps that we have run.
And you know, there have been occasions when he's been ultra fast in qualifying and then he shoots himself in the foot in the race. But today, he got behind Marco Andretti and he didn't force the issue. He waited for a heck of a long time before he finally made the move. So he has matured. Probably had plenty of coaching on the radio, but there's no question, that's not over yet. But if he continues as he is, there's no question that he's done anything but shoot himself in the foot today.
But let's go back and look at this year. Toronto was on the podium. He went to the back of the pack after the start because he had contact at the start in Toronto.
Yep.
So he didn't do anything crazy coming back up through the pack. Let's look at Long Beach. You know, he was on the podium at Long Beach. So he's settled into it, you know? I think that's the biggest thing that the guys on his pit stand is we just have to learn what we say to him to rein him in and say, you have a good car. You don't need to charge and get past Marco in these next two laps. Just wait. Wait. It will come.
He's going to cross the line here in a moment, and that will be five laps to go. Second is 4.7 seconds, and now Scott Dixon is 6.5 seconds behind.
Another tough day for Andretti Green Racing, 10th, 11th, 15th, and certainly such a scary moment for Tony Kanaan. Wasn't a team issue, just for some reason that fuel hose didn't slap shut. He didn't leave early, they didn't send him early. It's so interesting during the interview that he said he felt the spray. So he was already prepared and wanted to get out of there because he knows after feeling spray there could be a fire, got the visor down. That was some smart thinking.
And he said, I shut my eyes immediately. Yeah. So he knew. He really knew. But who would ever thought that you'd be looking at that graphic we just saw there with all AGR cars out of the top 10.
And there's always a chance of burning your palms in a car because they put leather on the palm because you got to get grip on the steering wheel, and all the back side of the hand is where the Nomex fire retardant is. So it is always potentially an issue to get burns on the front of your hands because you got to leave something there to get a good grip on the wheel.
Didn't you used to drive without gloves?
Not me, Robbie.
No.
Did you? No.
I thought he was going to segue to that side of the motion. I knew.
I was.
Yeah, I knew that's where you were going.
You got my number.
Yeah. The season's not over yet. Versus is taking you all the way to the end, and I got plenty of time to get in with you.
Yes, you do. I look forward to the duel.
Yeah, it's going to be fun, the last races of the year, because we've got some ovals, we've got some natural road courses, and we also have an incredible battle for the championship.
We do. And absolutely anxious to see how some of these aerodynamic changes play out for some of the side-by-side action we're going to see at Kentucky and just kind of what unfolds from there. What? A little more grass mowing, Matos.
Yep.
Now, you talk about the championship. Have we said that if it finishes now, do we have this right, that Dixon would actually move ahead of Franchitti? So even though he hasn't necessarily been out there in the front, that he's in great position now points-wise.
And let's just go back to that kind of pass that Elio tried on him earlier in that gaggle, and he was heads up to let him go there. And if we're looking at this screen here, we got Dixon, who somewhere in here has gotten, Elio's gotten back by Dixon, and Dixon's going back into
the
collection.
Now check this out now. See, that's the thing. We spoke a little bit too soon because Briscoe, who we were told is going to be fine, maybe is going to be fine because he seems to be now closing in on Dixon.
And this would give us the Penske 1-2-3.
Yeah. Now, where did I miss where Elio went back by there?
Hey, maybe looking here in turn one. Nope. Meanwhile, Conway is staying right up there with him. We will have a new points leader again if they finish the way they are running right now. Scott Dixon will go to the points lead, and
you know
Hannah
what?
Schechter is in the fence.
This is going to, well, where is he? This could be our, I think they're going to have to go full course for that.
That's definitely in a track out target
10,
zone.
Yeah.
So that will be a full course.
Wow, with two laps to go.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, this could be, yep, there's the little yellow widget.
Yep. Exciting for all of us from our vantage point. Not so exciting for Will Power.
Yep. white flag comes out with the caution flags, and so we will end this race under caution.
That's okay for Will.
Yeah.
There you go. Great for Willpower. Went from if there was going to have to be a one-lap shootout where he lost his big gap to okay.
Yep.
Thanks, Thomas Schechter.
And probably some pretty nervous moments for Scott Dixon, who thought maybe he was going to get some heat from Briscoe.
Yeah. Well, no question about it, Will Power dominated this race, showed his strength, and he can be so blindingly fast on some of these street and road courses. I just remember watching him last year in Australia and how he hammered the curbs there. And if he needed to go two tenths faster, it's like he could almost do it at will. If somebody's getting closer, he'd just go out and go faster. So he's got the speed. Now he's got a great win here.
And it'll be his first win in the IndyCar Series. And his fourth win in open wheel racing. He won at Las Vegas and Toronto in 2007 and at Long Beach last year. He becomes the 42nd driver to win an IndyCar Series event, and he is the first-time winner this year. And you see the standings at the top of the screen on our ticker, showing you that Dixon is going to be in the points lead by three over Franchitti after this race. Here are the Twin Checkers, and Will Power now officially is the winner of the Rexall Edmonton Indy for 2009. Great, great win and a great drive for Will Power. We'll be back to talk with him in just a moment here on Versus.
This is the clean bill of health you want. This is one of the prescriptions you take to achieve it. This is another. And another. The wrong medicine, or combination of the right medicines, can make your picture of good health murky. At the Medicine Shop Pharmacy, our pharmacist donors help you manage your medicines to make them really work for you. We just want to make that clear.
With just 6 grams of fat or less. Made fresh in front of you with toppings to fit your healthy lifestyle. Enjoy one today. Subway, think fresh, eat fresh.
Remember how Milt used to lose it when the copier didn't work? His face got all purple. This one time, it looked like he was helping a horse give birth.
Give it to me!
Then we got these multifunctional biz hubs from Konica Minolta.
The Biz Hub has this remote diagnostic technology called V-Care. It actually calls a service guy before a problem happens.
No more meltdowns.
Yeah, nothing but smooth sailing from here.
Mm. Give it to me! Give it to me!
New Bud Light Lime with a splash of 100% natural lime flavor.
It's estimated that each year, up to 300,000 Canadians are hospitalized because they took their medications incorrectly, or not at all. Many of us are so busy we simply don't refill our prescriptions, like Sally here. That's why Rexall saves you time by automatically refilling your prescription.
Rexall reminder ready.
And calls you only when it's ready for pickup. Take your medication seriously. We do. Rexall, a pharmacy first.
Susie McNeil, you're an award-winning singer, and you've quit smoking. How did you do it?
It was difficult, especially as a musician. It's definitely part of the lifestyle. My pharmacist recommended Thrive lozenges, and he said it actually doubles your chances of becoming smoke-free.
I hear 4 out of 5 people prefer Thrive lozenges.
That totally makes sense to me. They have a smooth, bold mint flavor, and you need that good taste to be able to stay with it. If you want help with quitting, try Thrive lozenges.
TSN Mobile makes navigating through the latest sports news, scores, and stats easier and more user-friendly. TSN Mobile, TSN.ca. On the go, anywhere you go. The 2009 Major League Soccer All-Star Game, Wednesday at 9:30 Eastern on TSN.
IRL Racing on TSN is brought to you in part by Honda.
Honda, the power of dreams.
Rexall Edmonton Indian Versus is brought to you by Rexall, a pharmacy first. And by Konica Minolta, global provider of BizHub and other award-winning business solutions for the desktop to the print shop. All you need is hub.com. And by Peak Performance Products. When you peak, you win.
The race has been won, and Izod salutes a winning performance. With Izod Victory Lane, here's Lindy with Will Power.
And this is Will Power's fourth win in open wheel racing, but his first in the IndyCar series. He has finished in the top six in four races, and now he gets the top spot. And you dominated out there, Will. You made it look easy, but talk about how physically demanding that was.
Actually, it was only the first stint was really tough, but then when I relaxed, felt really good at the end, had heaps of energy, and the car was really good all the time. It was a bit messy there when we were stuck behind Marco, but great job for the guys. Just so happy. It's like everything's going so well this year. I'm really, really glad to be a part of this team.
Let's talk about that with Marco. How much patience did that take?
Well, once I realized I couldn't get past, or it was going to be risky getting past, I just saved fuel and I was patient. And then when I saw my chance, his tires went off, I went for it. So it was a great day, you know. It was had a bit of everything. I loved that. Loved it.
And let's get down to it. Being a part-timer with Penske, how bad did you want this?
I wanted it bad. I mean, every time I get in the car, I want it bad. And, you know, sitting and watching is real tough, but I don't mind as long as I'm in this organization, because every time I'm in a car, it's a really good one.
Will Power, congratulations.
Thank you.
John Erickson, five races now. You have not finished outside the top six. You've been on the top of that box, but this is your first ever IndyCar Series victory. How does it feel?
Terrific. You can't say enough about Will, though. He did a terrific job. He did a good job at Long Beach, Indy, obviously, and I can't say enough about him. The guys had good stops. Obviously, the car was prepared good, and everybody did great.
You had a strong lead about 5 seconds, but you didn't lose a touch. And again, this is a hodgepodge crew that you had here. You didn't lose anything in that pit stop.
It's mostly the sports car crew, but they did a good job. We had a good gap, got into some traffic. That gap shortened up, so we tried to wait until we could get that gap wide enough. But yeah, good stops, terrific stops.
When you haven't had that first win, how hard was it for you up there on the box? Because it looked like it was the perfect day.
Well, it's like the rest of these guys up and down pit road. You always want that first one, and now we got it. It feels good.
Okay, congratulations. Kevin, you with Elio?
Elio Castroneves finishes right behind his teammate first. Will Power helped you out earlier this season. How happy are you for him to get to victory lane in the IndyCar series?
There is no doubt about when Team Penske told about Will Power would be in the team. I had no question that the talent is there. And I think everybody was always outspoken about that. It was just a matter of time. And hey, here we go. Today he did a hell of a job. I'm happy for him, obviously. And again, it was a big battle out there. It was very hard. It was very tough. And it towards the end, I was just pushing as hard as I could. Obviously, I want to win for my guys. But it turned out to be a 1-2 Penske finish. I wish Ryan would be there. But Scott sneaked it over there, right there in the end with the pit stop strategy. So that definitely showed that working together, it's paying off. And hey, now let's keep continuing working to help us stop the Ganassi guys. Today, so far, it worked.
You got to second with about 10 laps left, getting by Scott Dixon. How much did lap traffic come into that?
A lot. I mean, obviously, traffic, it was very, very difficult, especially just to follow. I mean, not only to be behind, but to follow. I mean, and keep it, like, with a good pace. Very, very hard. And you got to have the momentum there. We have, like, a bunch of cars together. I'm like, man, this is going to be my only chance. And I remember last year, Scott was in front of me. I'm like, we never got traffic. So this time I took advantage. It paid off.
Strong run for Elio Castroneves. He finishes second. Bob?
This is the 142nd victory for a Roger Penske-owned car in a major American open-wheel race. And the win comes in Roger's 1,200th start as a car owner. And here we salute the winning team members who, of course, play such an important role in getting their driver to victory lane. Will Power is the man in victory lane here at Edmonton. Back in a moment.
Remember how Milt used to lose it when the copier didn't work? His face got all purple. This one time, it looked like he was helping a horse give birth.
Give it to me!
Then we got these multifunctional biz hubs.
The power.
and by Mopar. Authentic performance. Standing by are the champion children from the Victory Lap Charity Program with a command to start your engines.
Go!
Closing door! You're my evil mother!
And 22 NASCAR late models fire up in front of a packed house. 8,000 fans here at Saint Eustache.
Well, Jacques Villeneuve gets the window net secured in place. No more autographs, Dave. It's time to get down to business.
We'll ride on board with Don Thompson Jr. today. He hopes to get his year back on track, starting right here in Saint Eustache. There's Anthony Simone, and we'll also ride along with Jason White, who will start in 17th. Now let's take a look at today's lineup for the Type 250 from Saint Eustache. On pole, as we heard, is the 17 of DJ Kennington. Outside front row will be Don Thompson Jr. in the Home Hardware Chevy. Barry native John Gaunt in the 12th car will start in third, and Andrew Ranger in the 27 outside of him in row number two. Row number three has Kerry Mix in the 02 and Scott Steckley in the Canadian Tire 22 will start to the outside of row three. Row four, Mark Dilley in the 9 and Jeff Lapsevich in the 23. Looking back to row number 5, Anthony Simone, and there is Jacques Villeneuve in the 7. Row number 6 has Ron Beauchamp Jr. He's your points leader in the 60, and Dave Whitlock in the 39 won the first time out here at Saint Eustache. Jonathan Bouvret starts in the 41, Ken Nunes in the 18, and then row number 8 has Brad Graham in the 19 and Jason Hathaway in the 3. Row number 9 is Jason White all the way from BC in the 21. And then it's Derek White, Quebec native, in the 99. Andre Corsall drives the 5, and Dexter Stacey is in the 55. Row number 11 has Joey Hansen in the 40. And then Hugo Vanini in the 97 will round out the field.
Well, we got trouble with the 21 car, Dave. It's not going to fire up as the parade lap is carrying on here. They're going to push it down to pit road and see what's wrong with that race car. Let's have a quick look inside. Oh, he's playing with the switches. Oh, we got some smoke underneath the dash. That's not good.
Obviously, something going wrong with the electrics. Hopefully, the crew can jump in there and rewire what they need to get them back in the field before we go to green.
We're on board with Ron Beauchamp Jr., that Mopar Dodge.
Beauchamp starting in the 11th position behind Jacques Villeneuve. And let's send it down trackside to our man, Todd. More news on today's event.
A couple of quick stories just before we go green. The French-Canadian racing tradition continues. Jonathan Bouvret, a local track champion here at Saint Eustache, also a provincial champion in today's field, running his first NASCAR Canadian Tire Series event. Quick to thank Alain LeBarras of this track, the owner and promoter of this event. Alain's so involved in racing that he's actually going to run the event as part of the nationwide racing weekend. Of course, he was a pretty good motorcycle racer in his day. Quick story as well, the 21 car of Jason White, the A&W car, an ignition wire problem. They're trying to fix it now just before we go green.
I can hear the motor come to life just in time, and he'll get that thing to the back of the pack.
And it would have been heartbreaking to see him not be able to start this race, coming all the way from Sun Peaks, British Columbia, last year's Rookie of the Year in the NASCAR Canadian Tire Series, looking to run strong here in 2009.
All into turn three for the final time. We're coming to the green flag. Watch these guys go up through the gearbox. They'll be hustling for turn one.
And watch Kennington and watch Thompson sitting on the front row. Now watch the flag stand as March Normandot has the green flag in hand.